Microphone check 1-2, 1-2-3-4. Microphone check 1-2. Thank you. Good evening and welcome to live coverage of Buffalo State College Club Hockey. The UNYCHL-CSCHC Showcase continues tonight with what should be a heck of a game between the Buffalo State College Bengals as the Bengals are playing host to the University of Tampa Spartans. Hello, my name is Aaron Elpern alongside Sean McHugh getting you ready for tonight's game with the Ivy Lee pregame show brought to you by Ivy Lee Pharmacy, a locally owned neighborhood pharmacy for over 60 years on Elmwood Avenue in Kenmore. And Sean, Buff State won their first game of the weekend series with the Florida schools last night, but it was hardly a work of art.
Absolutely, Aaron. The Buffalo State Bengals came out of this game with an 8-7 win over the Knights, as you said. Got off to the start that everybody wants to, led 5-0 at one point, but then the Knights just kept coming back, and they get all the credit in the world for battling back. Many teams would just hang it up and look on to the next game after going down 5-0 in the second, but a few moments of maybe looking ahead to tonight's opponent or maybe thinking that this one was in the bag, being how they have handled a lot of their opponents today, opened the door multiple times for UCF to get back into that game.
Yeah, UCF definitely made the Bengals pay for letting their foot off the gas a little bit. Nearly came out with a win here last night. Buff State, however, was led by number 8, Ben Gallivan. He had 2 goals and 1 assist. Mike Guerrero with 1 goal and 2 assists. And Colin Branca scored what would go on to be the game winner in his first game as a Bengal. Meanwhile, earlier in the night across town, it was the University of Tampa showing they were ready for the weekend with a convincing 6-1 win over the University at Buffalo. That makes the Spartans 11-1-1 on the year, as their start has them leading the Southern Collegiate Hockey Conference. To learn more about the Tampa Spartans, we check in again with Nick Gimble, SCHC broadcaster for the Embry-Riddle Eagles. Gimble saw Tampa play twice last weekend. I asked him what the Tampa Spartans do well.
Well, I think the shorter response is from the question of what doesn't Tampa do well. And when we look at point leaders for the entire SCHC, Joseph Davis, number 28, the defenseman, he leads the entire SCHC in points, 7 goals, 13 assists, 20 points. Behind him is one of his right wing teammates, William Cody, with 6 goals, 11 assists, 17 points. And then Stephen Buck, a third Tampa Spartan, is in the top 4 of points. So this Tampa team knows how to score, and they've got such incredible depth. Their lower level team, their D3 team, have outscored their opponents 93-11. And it carries over into the D2 games. I mean, just this past weekend, it was a battle for the number one spot in the SCHC. And Tampa came out with the weekend sweep, 5-4 win in Daytona against Embry-Riddle. And then they fought from behind to win 7-6 in overtime over at the Clearwater Ice Arena in the Home and Home Series. So this team is going to shove physicality in the face of their opponents, and they're going to do so by putting the puck in the back of the net along with it.
Do you feel like they've established themselves as the team to beat in the conference?
I would say so. The West Coast of Florida has dominated the SCHC in recent years. But especially this season, with the sweep over Embry-Riddle, Tampa is the team to beat right now out of the state of Florida.
Tampa is ranked number 7 according to the first CHF national rankings that came out this week. Buff State, meanwhile, is at number 19 according to myhockeyrankings.com. That makes this a big game for both clubs as they look to improve their resumes for nationals. Both teams are on the ice, and we're about ready to head to ice level to meet tonight's starting lineups. Good evening and welcome to the Buffalo State Ice Arena, and thank you for joining us for tonight's Collegiate Hockey Federation game between the University of Tampa and your Buffalo State Bengals. Introducing the starting lineup for the visiting Tampa Spartans. At forward, number 2, Ryan Andrews. Also at forward, number 9, William Cody. Starting at forward, number 61, Ryan Murray. On defense, number 20, Michael Pettijohn. Also on defense, number 8, Christian Kukis. Starting in goal for Tampa is number 1, Shea Grant. And the head coach of the Tampa Spartans is Steve Kuchera. Now the starting lineup for your Buffalo State College Bengals. Starting at left wing from Montreal, Quebec, number 3, Michael Guerrera. At center from Amherst, New York, number 53, Brett Sardina. At right wing from Kenmore, New York, number 8, Ben Gallivan. Starting on defense from Amherst, New York, number 13, Ryan Kelly. Also on defense from Grand Island, New York, number 88, Adam Brennan. Starting in goal for the Bengals from Charlotte, North Carolina, number 1, A.J. White. The head coach of the Bengals is Tim Turner, with assistant coaches Jeff Shefchek and Pat Krebs. At this time, we'd like to recognize players from each team for their exceptional play in the month of October. Coming up this week, the CHF will honor its Players of the Month, and the defensive and offensive players of October are on the ice tonight. If both players can meet at center ice to commemorate this moment, the CHF October Defensive Player of the Month from Tampa, number 8, Christian Kukas. And the CHF October Offensive Player of the Month from Buffalo State College, number 8, Ben Gallivan. If both players could meet at center ice to take a photo to commemorate the moment, and congratulations for your outstanding play in the month of October. At this time, we ask that you rise if you are able and stand for the playing of our national anthems. It's the UNYCHL SCHC Showcase continuing this weekend here in Buffalo. And this is game 2 for both the University of Tampa and Buffalo State College. Both teams coming out with wins last night. It was Tampa winning 6-1 over the University of Buffalo. And Buffalo State surviving a comeback from the University of Central Florida winning by a score of 8-7. Both teams very highly regarded when it comes to the national rankings, so this should be an important matchup for each team to see where they stack up nationally against some other strong teams.
Absolutely. Both teams are here trying to make a case for where they should be seated in nationals. As we are aware, both teams are basically thinking nationals are bust, as they should. This is a good early to mid-season preview of two teams that should be contending not just to make it to nationals, but are looking to make noise. And we're going to be treated to a preview of two teams that are expected to see each other late into the national tournament.
Plenty of other CHF teams around the country and locally looking to improve their rankings. Quick look at the UNY CHL scoreboard presented by Militello Realty, Western New York's premier commercial real estate broker. And we have an upset in the UNY CHL today. It was Cortland coming out with a 3-2 shootout victory over Binghamton. So that is both number one teams in the country coming into this week. Farmingdale and Binghamton losing this weekend. So a chance for teams to move up in the rankings. Both of these teams look to do so, and we're underway from the Buff State Ice Arena. Puck in the Buff State zone right now. Picked up there by Ryan Kelly. Gets a D-to-D pass to Adam Brennan. Brennan chips it off the boards to Ben Gallivan, the recently announced October Player of the Month for the CHF. Actually, both Players of the Month, both offensive and defensive Players of the Month here in this game. Ben Gallivan, the Offensive Player of the Month. And his number 8 counterpart on the Tampa side, Christian Kukis, named the Defensive Player of the Month by the CHF.
I expect that to be a battle we're going to be paying a lot of attention to throughout this game. The best forward and the best defenseman are going to be on the ice together a lot tonight.
And really, both teams have tremendous depth. You realize that when you look over some of the point totals on both teams. You have multiple players, 8 players in total on the Tampa roster with 10 points or more on the season. Meanwhile, 6 Bengals have 10 points or more this season from the Buffalo State side of things. So both teams have a lot of firepower and a lot of depth.
Those are the teams that are going to make it far at nationals, are the teams that can throw line after line at you, because one, you don't have to rely on one line. Also, a bad day doesn't kill you, or you can be keyed on, and you can dictate matchups the way you want to when you have the lines both of these teams have. And today, it's going to be strength on strength on strength. I expect this to be a dogfight from start to finish.
Puck deep in the offensive zone for the Bengals. Comes out in front. Anton Rupert almost getting a shot in on goal there. Just couldn't quite get it in on net. Josie Davis back in the other direction for Tampa. Gets wide on Ryan Hahn, then takes it in behind the net. Josie Davis, the defenseman, is the leading scorer on this Tampa team, so definitely a player to keep an eye on, number 28, as he is dangerous whenever he has the puck on his stick. Takes the puck off of Elliot Hunt's stick right there, and then fires a backhander in on net, saved by the goaltender number 1, A.J. White. A.J. White back in net for Buff State tonight. His 7th game of the season. He comes in with a 5-1 record, a 2.90 goals against average, and a .920 save percentage.
We were just talking about Josie Davis right there, and you got a little glimpse of what that kid can bring to the table each and every night. He led the rush in, put a nice move on defenseman Ryan Hahn and created a scoring chance, and then right after that, retreated back to his point position and kept a clearing attempt in and got a shot on net. So that's a little bit of what we can expect to see from the big defenseman for the Spartans.
Cole Newman getting it into the neutral zone. John Glasgow finishes the rest of the way into the offensive zone. Now the Bengals putting on some pressure on the forecheck here. Joe Lotempio up against the near boards. He's got 3 different Spartans on him, but keeps it deep in the zone. Pass goes around behind the net. Now it's Parrish on the far wall trying to get it out, getting some help from Davis. They can't get it past the defenseman, Ryan Miller, though. Finally did manage to get it away from him, but there's a penalty called as Miller took a hit right into the Tampa bench, and it's going to be an elbowing penalty called, and it's number 11, Grant Parrish, heading to the box. So just less than 2 minutes into the action here from the Buffalo State Ice Arena, we have our first power play of the night, and it's the Buff State Bengals with the early man advantage.
Similar to yesterday as well, Aaron. The Bengals, you know, granted they weren't hemmed in their own end like they were to start yesterday, but they get an early opportunity to get some shots on goal and get some puck possession, and to nobody's surprise, they're sending out the big guns right away.
The Bengals have been very good on special teams throughout the year. 15 of 36 so far this year on the power play. 42% conversion rate, very solid. They scored a couple power play goals last night. Ben Gallivan ripping a shot from the right point. Would have gone wide, but it was caught by the gloved hand of the Tampa goaltender tonight, number 1, Shea Grant. Grant just hangs on for a whistle as 13 seconds ticked off of the power play time there. Shea Grant coming into this game with a perfect 5-0 record. He has a 1.20 goals against average and a .935 save percentage in his 5 outings this season. Puck sent back into the Buffalo State zone and picked up behind the net by Ben Gallivan. Gallivan starts out now to the left of the net, sends a pass up to Anton Rupert. Rupert across the blue line, dumping it deep into the Tampa zone, chasing in after it himself. Chips it away from a defenseman, then chases it down in the far corner. Newbridge slows it down to set up the power play. Back to Guerrera. Guerrera fans on a shot, but keeps it in. Gets that shot then in through traffic. Looked like it might have hit the side of the net there as it went through two different Bengal bodies in front of the net. Picked up on the play by Pettijohn, and he clears the zone for Tampa with a minute 8 remaining in the Bengals' power play. Ben Gallivan back for the loose puck again. Gallivan with some speed and a lane up the left side. Gets it into the offensive zone. Lets a shot go. That hit a defenseman's skate and went wide, but Guerrera picks it up. Now in behind the net looking for a play. Guerrera back to the point. He's got Cole Newman there. Newman goes across to Gallivan. Gallivan rips the shot right in on goal, but seen pretty clearly by Grant. Grant makes the save with the glove hand. Hangs on for another faceoff in the defensive zone with 47 seconds now remaining in the Tampa penalty.
Bengals started to get a little bit of their legs going on that power play. Good possession there, a little game of cat and mouse by Mike Guerrera and Ben Gallivan at the point. Gallivan not afraid to shoot today. He's looking to flex that offensive player of the month on the defensive player of the month, and you like to see it. So definitely big goaltender here, a really big in stature. Got to shoot a lot and get traffic in front of him. You're going to beat him today.
Tampa penalty to number 11, Grant Parrish. 2 minutes for elbowing. Parrish, 2 minutes for elbowing. Time of the penalty, 1:59. Bengals keeping the pressure on the power play here. Down to Cole Newman on the hash mark. Sends a backhand pass down below the net. Joe Lotempio in there putting some pressure on, but Josie Davis comes out with the puck. And now Davis has a head of steam up the near side. Davis in across the blue line, looking for a pass. He gets it into the slot, just unable to handle it. There was Ryan Murray. Bengals now looking to counter. Davis, though, forces a turnover and drives it in towards the Bengals net yet again. Takes a hit there in the corner as it's Ryan Kelly picking it up, but that's going to be an interference call as Ryan Hahn laid the hit on Josie Davis there away from the puck, and that's going to result in an interference penalty to the Bengals, and so Tampa now gets their first opportunity with the man advantage.
Not a smart penalty there by Ryan Hahn. Josie Davis was working hard down low. The Bengals are having a very difficult time getting the puck off his stick. Hahn tried to dislodge him, but the puck was a good 10 feet away from Davis when the hit came. That's going to be interference every time.
Puck deep in the Buff State zone now. As it's going to be Ryan Miller coming out with the loose puck off the draw, getting it into the neutral zone. Now into the offensive zone with a chance here on the penalty kill. Miller goes around the net, looking to make a play there. Nobody there to make a pass to, but it comes out to Alex Militello, who lets a shot go in on net, killing off just a little bit more time on this Bengals penalty. Josie Davis now picking it up for Tampa, slowing things down, carrying it out of his zone slowly, now through the neutral zone. Chips it in just into the Bengals zone, but nobody there to chase it down for Tampa. That gives Adam Brennan plenty of time to clear it through the neutral zone and all the way back into Tampa territory. And the Spartans will have to chase it back there to start their power play up again. Stephen Buck with it. Sends a pass into the neutral zone, set up there for Grant Parrish. Parrish into the offensive zone now, setting it up now at the half wall. Parrish looking for a pass. He's got Militello on him. He goes far cross ice where he has Christian Kukas. Kukas looking for a shooting or passing lane. Feeds it down low. Hoffberg's pass in between two different Tampa Spartans, and it goes all the way back down into the Tampa end. A minute exactly now left in the Buff State penalty. Josie Davis, the big defenseman, setting up behind his own net. Brett Sardina with some light pressure from Buff State. As the pass comes up to Ryan Andrews up the left wing. Andrews gains the offensive zone, but he takes a hit there. Gives the Bengals a chance to clear. Anton Rupert getting it into the neutral zone, but it's going to be Stephen Buck back in the other direction for Tampa. Buck sends it in behind the net where Adam Brennan finds it for Buff State. He's got a man on him, though. Both players go hard into the corner as carried out from behind around the corner now, and an opportunity for the Spartans to set it up now with 27 seconds remaining in their power play. Andrews back to the point. He's got Pettijohn here. Gives it back to Andrews. Andrews looking for a shooting lane. Hits a skate and goes wide. Picked up then behind the net, as it was McMahon trying to find something there. Back to the point, kept in by Murray. He's got a man on him, does a good job to keep it in, gets it to Andrews. Andrews with the puck in his skates.
Great defense by Kelly.
And
right
Kelly
there.
Gets the puck off of his stick, killing off the final few seconds here of this penalty as 3-2-1 tick off. Ryan Hahn comes out of the penalty box, and both teams have successfully killed off their first penalties tonight.
That got tense for a second there, Aaron, but Buffalo State did a really good job of eliminating the high danger scoring chances, which is exactly what you cannot allow these UT Spartans to have at any point.
Puck comes into the neutral zone. Ryan Andrews banks it off the boards, but it ends up right on the stick of Ryan Miller. Miller sends a backhand pass into the neutral zone. He's got Anton Rupert. Rupert has a little bit of room to work. Loads up a slap shot that looked like it was knuckling as it came in on goal. A difficult job for Grant to handle that one, though he did make the save. The rebound came out, but there was nobody there from Buff State to find it. That allows Tampa to clear the zone and break it into the Buff State end. Ryan Miller and Joe Lotempio battling against a Tampa player in that far corner. A second Tampa player now slides in to help out as the puck is pinned in there, and the four players trying to dig it out finally does come out, as it's going to be Alex Hussey trying to send it out of the zone now. Hussey with a little bit of room, avoids a check, gets it just inside the blue line of Tampa, but the Spartans come up with possession of it and ship it back into the neutral zone. And it looks like we're going to have another penalty called as the referee behind the play has his arm up. As the Tampa player was down on the ice, didn't exactly get a chance to see what happened, but it looked like the signal was a hit from behind.
Yeah, the Tampa player looked like number 23, Cameron Sacco, got hit from behind by Elliot Hunt. Hunt's not really arguing either. He got him. I mean, the puck was well past us, and we had already tracked it into the offensive zone. But then I looked down, and Sacco was kind of down on it, on his knees, kind of leaned up against the boards.
Buffalo State penalty to number 9, Elliot Hunt. 2 minutes for hitting from behind. Hunt, 2 minutes for hitting from behind. Time of the penalty, 7:01. Puck fired out of play there, right off the initial faceoff on the power play. So just 7 seconds gone in the penalty to Buff State as Guerrera sets up to take the draw against Hoffberg. Hoffberg winning that draw, back to the point to Buck, and Buck gets it down low for Tampa. Josie Davis on the far side now, looking to set it up. He's got a man on him. Good defense there by Ryan Kelly, getting the puck off of Josie Davis's stick. But Kelvin unable to clear the zone. Now Davis in the slot with it. Gets it to Kukas. Great save by A.J. White. Got himself squared up to the shooter very nicely there and made a fairly easy save on what was a dangerous chance. Hard slap shot taken from the left point by Stephen Buck. Looked like it might have gotten deflected on the way through. Ends up going up and out of play, and we'll have another stoppage here with a minute 29 remaining in the penalty to Elliot Hunt.
A.J. White doing a very, very good job of staying calm and composed in the goal crease right there. That puck was, the play was moving and moving. All of a sudden, Stephen Buck came in on A.J.'s blocker side, and A.J., instead of going out too high to challenge, stayed firm in his crease and allowed the puck to hit him, and then there was no rebound that got made its way to the front of the net.
But sending that cross ice pass, had a nice look there as Christian Kukas was wide open on the near side after taking that pass from Josie Davis, just couldn't quite get it past A.J. White. Nice save there. Tampa, though, keeping it going in the offensive zone as they have a nice little bit of setup here on their power play. Josie Davis on the near hash marks with two different Bengals watching him. Back to the point to Kukas. Snapshot taken by Buck, saved by White. Puck is cleared to the blue line, but Kukas keeps it in. Buck fans on that slap shot. Puck comes out to the far wall. A chance for Anton Rupert to get it out of the zone, but he only gets it as far as the blue line. Kukas keeping it in. Shot in on goal and a save made by A.J. White. Puck now at the near point. Shot taken well wide. Now a chance for Buff State to clear. Anton Rupert doing so, sending the backhand all the way down the rest of the length of the ice. 35 seconds now left in the penalty to Buff State as Stephen Buck sets it up in his own zone. Puck with the cross ice pass to Murray. Murray with Alex Militello on him. Tries to get around the two different Bengal players there, but does manage to come out with the puck as three different Spartan players are down low. Pass comes out towards the point, deflected away by Glasgow into the neutral zone with 12 seconds remaining in the Buff State penalty. Ryan Murray regrouping in the neutral zone, getting a pass back to Pettijohn as 5 seconds now remain in the penalty to Hunt as Tampa dumps it into the Buff State zone. On with two different Spartans on him. So those players try to dig the puck out of the far boards here. And coming out with it, it's going to be the Spartans on the play there. It's Andrews trying to chip a pass into the neutral zone, but it's Alex Militello getting in the way, making sure that puck gets to center ice. Bengals making a change here. Spartans trying to catch them in the middle of that change. Good defense there is stepping up into those offensive lanes where the two defensemen there, Brennan and Miller. Puck now in the neutral zone right below our broadcast position. Ryan Andrews coming away with it. Andrews lets that shot go through a screen. Save made by White as a player goes sliding into the crease. It looked like he caught a little bit of A.J. White on the way through, then hitting the post. And the official is going to rule that the faceoff will go into the neutral zone as the Tampa player was responsible for the net coming off. And that faceoff will be coming up right in front of the Buff State bench with 10:23 left in the period.
That's a set play, and that was almost worked to perfection there by Tampa. That little two-on-two-man game, the carrying forward takes the shot at the far goaltender's pad. A.J. White makes the save, but that was the one time a rebound came in front, and luckily for the Bengals, Ryan Miller had his head up and was able to get the puck out of there as the Tampa forward came flying in to try and dive and put the puck in the empty net, and it looks like the net broke.
Yeah, it looks like we have a little bit of a delay here as the official is skating the net the length of the ice back to the Zamboni door, and I got to only imagine that there is something amiss with the net, and it is no longer working in its proper fashion, and they're looking for a replacement now. We have both officials, actually two of the officials over here talking to the rink attendant, trying to get that sorted out. But while we have a moment, do want to remind you that support for Buffalo State Club Hockey comes from Town Auto. For over 50 years, a proud member of the Western New York community, putting customers' needs first and helping them find the right car at the right price. The dealerships of Town Auto make buying a car easy, whether online, over the phone, or in store. We love our town. Supporters also include the Hurdle Parker Liquor Store. With everyday low prices on a great selection of wines and spirits, the Hurdle Parker Liquor Store on the corner of Hurdle and Parker in North Buffalo. Our supporters also include the law offices of Nicholas J. Narchis, advocate for Western New Yorkers with blue-collar roots, providing efficient and cost-effective representation, offices in Lockport and Geneseo. Online, narchislaw.com. Buffalo State Club Hockey supporters also include 95 Nutrition, healthy and delicious meal prep and delivery, making it simple to live a healthy lifestyle and to reach your nutritional goals. Enjoy the convenience of healthy eating with 95 Nutrition. Order online from their 8 Western New York locations. More information, 95nutrition.com. And support for Buffalo State Club Hockey also comes from Envious Gamewear, the official uniform supplier of the Bengals, making high-end custom team uniforms, bags, and apparel. Find them online, enviousgamewear.com. I believe we have things sorted out and a new net here, Sean.
Yes, and this net has not been shot at a lot, Aaron. Look how white that twine is.
I feel like they got we just got the varsity net.
Look at this. You know, first they go to nationals, now they get to use the varsity nets. Eventually, they're going to be the D3 team.
I think we're just going to have to request the nice nets for every game now.
Well, we'll see how this goes.
Good call. All right, so as we're ready to get started here, just a quick reset, 10:23 left here in the first period. No score yet between the Bengals and Spartans. We have a new net now in the Buff State end of things. And the faceoff will be coming up in the neutral zone right in front of the Buff State bench. And Tampa wins that draw cleanly there as it was Courant winning the draw, actually coming back into his own zone, however, as he won it too cleanly. Josie Davis starting the breakout for the Tampa Spartans through the neutral zone. He's got Courant there. Sends a pass up there. And now Courant on that back door. Almost a really nice setup there, as there was a good look there from Justin Evans and Jake Courant on the two-on-two play. Puck at the blue line. Bengals unable to clear the zone on the first attempt. Branca trying to get it out on the second attempt now, is successful in doing so. And the Spartans are going to have to regroup. They do so quickly, bring it into the offensive zone with Davis. Davis spins, feeds a pass into the slot. Player unable to get that pass out of his skates, though, and get the shot in on goal, but Davis keeps it in at the far point. Now into the slot, tries to get a shot in on goal. Looks like Bengal player got a stick on him there just to kind of keep that shot from having a lot on it. Got a lot on in that one, though, but it hit a body in front and went wide. Bengals now trapped in their zone a little bit, trying to settle things down and get it out into the neutral zone, hopefully back down into Tampa territory. But comes back to the near point here. Good play by Branca to make sure that Davis couldn't pick that one up. Bengals making a change, though, and Tampa quickly trying to take advantage of it. But Davis takes that shot, and it goes straight out of play. And the play continuing, though, as the official did not blow the play dead. That was a strange occurrence there as the play puck clearly went out of play. The official did not blow it dead. Now the Bengals are going to get a breakaway out of it, maybe. Elliot Hunt coming in with Schultz. Hunt just slowly losing control of the puck there on the far side, unable to get that pass in on goal and unable to develop an actual scoring opportunity out of that rush. And that could have developed into something nicely, just a little bit of a bouncing puck on Hunt there on the far side. Bengals, though, keeping it in the offensive zone. Zach Schultz behind the net looking for a passing lane. He's got a man on him, losing control of the puck. And now here come the Spartans.
There it is.
Zone, but a big hit by Ryan Hahn as he lined up Ryan Andrews perfectly just outside the Tampa blue line. Shot is dumped in on net by Hunt from just outside of the blue line. But the goaltender had maybe a little bit of difficulty with the save. Not the cleanest save as he would have liked. A little bit of difficulty for Tampa now trying to get it into the offensive zone as it's going to be Rupert coming in the other direction. Right back to Cameron Sacco, and now an opportunity for Tampa to break it out. Into the neutral zone, it's William Cody. Into the offensive end, takes a shot, but it goes wide, comes out of the zone, basically starts the breakout for the Bengals. Elliot Hunt now into the offensive zone, drops a pass for Schultz. Schultz tries to chip it around the defenseman. Good defensive play, though, as Kukas wouldn't let him get past.
Not the defenseman you're going to pull that on. Not him.
Pass in towards the net. Puck was laying there briefly as it hit the side of the net. Unable to get to it was Schultz, though. The Bengals do find possession of it. Anton Rupert in behind the net looking for a pass as he skates backwards along the goal line. Back to the point to Kelly. Kelly's shot hits a body and goes wide. Back up the rebound, though, it's Elliott Hunt. Cycling it down low for Schultz. Schultz tries to get that pass out in front. Kukis getting the stick in the way there, though. And starting the breakout for Tampa. Through the neutral zone, it's Andrews. Andrews getting it deep into the offensive end, looking for a pass as he stops in the corner. Gets it back down low, though. First one too, it's Adam Brennan. He ships it off the glass, gets it up to Gallivan. Gallivan quickly to Sardina. Sardina through the neutral zone, takes a bit of a hook. No call on the play there. Tampa player looked back at the official like he was expecting the call. Didn't happen though. Bengals maintaining possession. Pass just a little bit off the mark though as it was coming back to the point to Brennan. Good play there by A.J. White to move it out of danger and get it up ice. Herrera taking a shot as he gained the blue line. Blocked on the way through by Pettijohn, up and out of play. And finally, after a couple of minutes without a whistle, we have a stoppage in play with 6:54 to go in the first period. A lot of action in this game so far, but no score yet.
Yes, absolutely. And the Spartans are doing a really, really nice job of keeping in the shot lanes. You want to see the Bengals be just a touch more patient right there. They're running gunning, which is a good thing to do when you're facing a goaltender like Shea White, but the Bengals have fired the last three shot attempts right into shin guards. Maybe you want to see them wait it out or maybe take an extra pass if they can.
Neutral zone. It's going to be Gallivan picking it up. Gallivan now carrying it into the offensive zone, dumping it deep. Bengals now putting some forecheck pressure on. Sardina with a quick shot there from the perimeter. Grant had to be quick to make sure he saw that one and got the pad on it. Made a solid save though. Now Tampa breaking it through the neutral zone. Adam Brennan in his own end now. Can't start the Bengals breakout. Pass up to Guerrera. Guerrera tries to bank it off the boards. That one hits a Tampa player, but Guerrera ends up with the puck back on a stick. And he gets it to Adam Brennan. Brennan up to Sardina. Sardina going one on two into the offensive zone. Almost ended up getting through the players there. Ends up with the puck behind the net, though. Losing control of it, though, to Piccarello. Up to Stephen Buck just at the blue line. Drops the pass there. Now looking to set something up in the offensive zone. The Tampa Spartans, it comes in front of the net. A little difficulty handling there from A.J. White. Did manage to get a glove on it, though, in the end as it looked like he juggled it there for a couple of moments. Did manage to put the catching glove on top of it, though. And that will force a faceoff in the Tampa offensive zone. 5:49 now to play here in the first period.
This game has a physical element to it, but it's different than the UCF game was. These teams are playing hard and trying to play for the puck. Not a lot of bodying going on, minus a few big hits here and there, but both teams are playing really, really strong, physical, in-your-face defense. And there's a lot of transition in this game as well.
Cole Newman in transition with some speed through the neutral zone, losing control of it just outside of the Tampa blue line. Gives the Spartans a chance to counter, and they get it into the offensive zone with Curran. Curran in the near corner fires a pass out in front. Nobody there, though. That gives the Bengals a chance to clear the zone. Lasko putting some pressure on, hoping to chase down this one and negate the icing, but he was unable to beat Cameron Sacco to the hash marks, and that will result in an icing on the play. The faceoff coming back into Buffalo State territory.
Glasgow was looking for a stretch pass there from Cole Newman. I don't think Cole Newman saw him until it was too late right there. Glasgow was calling for it and banging the stick on the ground. But the thing to watch here is Glasgow was able to get behind him, so maybe there's something to be seen there.
Puck comes back to the point. Kukas keeping it in for Tampa. But it comes back to Glasgow now here at the near boards. That gives him a chance to clear it out of the zone through the neutral zone all the way into Tampa territory. And Cole Newman putting some pressure on the defenseman there. Turnover there just inside the blue line as Glasgow picks off that pass. Unable to step around the man there, though. And that creates a 3-on-2 in the other direction for Tampa. Drop pass for Andrews at the top of the circle. Lets the shot go. Looked like it might have caught a piece of the outside of the post before going wide. Now comes back to the point to Pettijohn. Pettijohn across to Kukas. Rebound shot and deflection in on net. That one hit the side of the cage. And now back to the left point to Kukas. Down low to Andrews. His pass doesn't connect and allows Glasgow to carry it out of his zone. Then sends a backhand through the neutral zone, and that allows Pettijohn to gain possession for Tampa. Aaron pass there just inside the blue line for Tampa as Branca stepped into that passing lane. Gosin now putting some pressure on in the far corner. Gosin and Branca. It's Branca coming out of there with it. Tries to make a pass to Militello, but it's in Militello's skates. Good play, though, by Alex to pick up that loose puck coming from behind and quickly getting a shot in on goal. Great blocker save made there by Grant.
Militello looks like he's getting his legs back after being off for the beginning of this season. There's the forecheck we've become so accustomed to seeing from him.
Pair Irish dumping it in for Tampa now with 4 minutes to go in period number one. Adam Brennan setting up behind his own net, getting a pass up the right wing to Alex Militello. Militello through the neutral zone, goes off the skate of Alex Gosen, then into the offensive zone for the Bengals. But coming up with possession there is going to be Jake Thane. Thane gets it to Josie Davis. Davis evades one forechecker, then feeds a pass up. Tampa's breaking it through the neutral zone as Parrish dumps it in.
Back off the bench.
Yeah, that ended up hitting a Buff State player on the bench. And that will result in a stoppage in play. 3:38 now remaining in the first period. Still no score yet between the University of Tampa and Buffalo State College. And faceoff coming up right at the center ice dot as we are ready to get started here yet again. It's going to be Rupert and Hoffberg on the draw.
Bengals have been... Bengals are getting a lot more pressure than they were in the beginning of the period. They're getting some shots and they're getting some chances, and most of all, they're having some puck possession. Because for a stretch there, Tampa was playing for minutes at a time in the Bengals' end. Bengals have returned the favor and put some pressure on them. They just got to get one of those quality scoring chances.
But in the Buff State zone right now, Hoffberg setting it up down low. Good passes there down below the goal line as Tampa tries to get the Buff State defenders moving there. State manages to clear the zone and now putting some pressure on the defensive players. Elliott Hunt quickly into the offensive zone. Passes banked off the boards and Josie Davis starts the breakout for Tampa. Stephen Buck in the neutral zone gains the blue line. He's got a man on him, drops the pass back to Davis. Davis looking for a lane there. That pass is intercepted though, and it's turned right back over by the Bengals. There's Buck now on the far wall. Kept in on the play by Aldridge. Aldridge and Buck in there trying to come up with the loose puck, but it's going to be the Bengals coming out with it. Anton Rupert now. Rupert carrying the puck out of his own zone. He's got two different Bengals players skating with him through the neutral zone. It comes out into the side. Good defensive play to negate that rush, and now Buck comes back in the other direction trying to start a rush for the Tampa Spartans. Good defensive play on the back check there by Zach Schultz, taking the puck off of his stick, allowing the Bengals to counter. Now Anton Rupert coming back in the opposite direction. Let's the shot go. Good bit on that snapshot, but it just missed the far post wide. 2:20 now remaining in the first period as Courant drives into the zone for Tampa. Loses control of it and goes into the far corner. Guerrero with a man on him there, getting some help from Anton Rupert. Three Bengals players now over there trying to come up with the loose puck, and it's going to be Ryan Hahn doing so. Hahn, though, has two different men on him, unable to get that pass up the left wing, and now it's pinned against the boards yet again with a minute 57 in the first period. Tampa coming out of the corner with the puck, a backhand pass into the slot. That one doesn't connect. It's going to be Michael Guerrero through the neutral zone. Guerrero with three men on him, pretty easily getting the puck off of his stick and allowing for a transition effort. A nice hit there just inside the Buff State blue line, negating that one by Ryan Miller. Miller then chips it through the neutral zone as the two teams seem to be playing a lot of hockey in center ice at the moment. Just inside the Tampa blue line as Sardina tries to send it down deep before taking a hit with a minute 28 to go in the period. Finding possession with Pettijohn. Nice pass to Murray. It comes to the Buff State bench as the Bengals were making a change. No call made on that play, though. There was the potential there for the too many men call. As the Tampa Spartans find control of the loose puck in center ice and dump it into the offensive zone. Pass through the legs of Gallivan. A little bit sloppy there. Doesn't end up getting hurt by it as Bengals manage to clear the zone and get it into the offensive end. Lasco with some light pressure here in the offensive zone as Pettijohn looks to start the breakout. Puts it up to Murray. Murray looking for a pass there. Feeds it up the right wing wall. And he's got William Cody there in front of the Buff State bench. As there's now 46 seconds left in the period as the shot is taken from the right point by Pettijohn, right in on goal. A.J. White swallows it up, holds on to the rebound. And he'll have a faceoff coming up to his glove hand side with 44 seconds remaining in the period. Still no score yet between Buff State and the University of Tampa.
Bengals are trying a little too much of the fancy stick handling, you know, sick through the legs, no-look passes. That is not going to work on this team. They got to go get back to the fundamentals, get the puck out of the zone, tape-to-tape passing, and get out of their own end.
Dangerous shot there as Kukas got it right in on goal. The rebound came out. Cleared out of danger, though, before any Tampa player is able to get to it, though. Tampa doing a good job of setting up in the Buff State zone and creating opportunities. Puck in the neutral zone now. It's going to be Kukas trying to drive back into the offensive zone. Pass comes out in front, cleared out of danger there with 12 seconds to go in the period. Tampa still looking to get another opportunity or two before the period ends. Back to the point to Murray. His shot goes wide and off the boards with 4 seconds in the period. Cole Newman then does a good job of chipping it through the neutral zone and into the Tampa end to finish things off here in the first period. lot of activity in the first period, but none of it on the actual goal department, as the first 20 minutes of play ends in a 0-0 tie. Sean, what did you see from the two teams there?
Two teams that are very evenly matched right now. Bengals are a very strong offensive team, and the Spartans are a very strong defensive team, and it's strength versus strength right now. Goaltenders both flawless and both played well. Goaltender, it's not like one goaltender wasn't asked to make any saves. I would have to say A.J. White got probably the higher danger of the scoring chances, but if there's an edge, it's not by a lot. What I'd like to see from the Bengals is less guys trying to go through the whole team, less shooting from the perimeter when there's no screen in front. And don't get me wrong, I mean, there's a time and a place for all of that, but with defensemen as strong and that can come out by committee the way the Spartans can do that, you really are better off getting possession and working for the shot. I mean, you don't want to pass up good shots, but like between the leg passes and the no-look backhands and the, you know, trying to do the Kuznetsov no-look behind the back pass in front, that looks great if you bury it, and it puts a great highlight on our YouTube channel. But you're trying to win this game, and that's just a team that's just not going to let you get away with that today.
Yeah, it might be a case where you definitely have to have a little bit more respect for your opponents. And this is a very good team that has come in here from Tampa. They're playing strong. They're playing very well, I think, here in this game. And Buff State Bengals would be wise to treat them with a touch more respect and to play it a little bit more of the safer play as opposed to trying to make the fancy play that looks nice.
We definitely want to, and I apologize for how this might sound, we want to know where the line between confident and cocky is right now, because this is a team, these Tampa Spartans, this is a team that will throw that right back in your face and laugh at you. So you definitely don't try. If you can do it, do it. But it's not working.
And I definitely think that the Bengals were guilty of being on the wrong side of that line last night against Central Florida. Not as bad here tonight, for certain.
No, not
at all. But, you know, still a little bit to clean up in that regard. Support for Buffalo State Club Hockey is brought to you by Militella Realty, Western New York's premier commercial real estate broker to buy, sell, or lease any office, industrial, retail, or investment property. Trust the unparalleled knowledge and experience of Militella Realty. Online, militello.com. Our coverage also brought to you by Ivy League Pharmacy, a locally owned neighborhood pharmacy for over 60 years. If you're traveling to Canada, PCR COVID tests are available at Ivy League with a quick one-hour turnaround. Ivy League Pharmacy, 2446 Elmwood Avenue in Kenmore. This broadcast brought to you by Town Auto. For over 50 years, a proud member of the Western New York community, putting customers' needs first and helping them find the right car at the right price. The dealerships of Town Auto make buying a car easy, whether online, over the phone, or in store. We love our town. Supporters also include the Hurdle Parker Liquor Store. With everyday low prices on a great selection of wines and spirits, the Hurdle Parker Liquor Store on the corner of Hurdle and Parker in North Buffalo. Supporters also include the law offices of Nicholas J. Narchis, an advocate for Western New Yorkers with blue-collar roots. Providing efficient and cost-effective representation, find them online at narchislaw.com. And supporters also include 95 Nutrition, healthy and delicious meal prep and delivery, making it simple to live a healthy lifestyle and reach your nutritional goals. Enjoy the convenience of healthy eating with 95 Nutrition. More information, 95nutrition.com. We're going to step away here for a moment as the first intermission is underway. Zamboni is on the ice and both teams are waiting in the locker rooms, getting ready for second period play. We're going to take a little bit of a break, and then we'll be back for second period play ourselves. Our score after one, 0-0 between Buffalo State and the University of Tampa. And welcome back inside the Buffalo State Ice Arena. About ready for second period play between the University of Tampa and Buffalo State College. As both teams have now taken the ice, Tampa now coming onto the ice. Buffalo State already here, as we have no score after 20 minutes of play. A very interesting first period of play. A lot of activity, but no scoring. As we await our game's first goal and await the start of the second period. Hello, my name's Aaron Elpern, joined on the call tonight by Sean McHugh. And Sean, both teams showcasing what they do well there in that first period.
Absolutely. Tampa Spartans, very, very strong defensive team. I mean, not to take anything from their offense, but their big guns and their players of note are on the back end, especially with Josie Davis and Christian Kukas. And the Bengals were trying to go at them with their big guns, Rupert and Guerrera. Definitely wouldn't say they've been shut down. I mean, I know it's 0-0, but, you know, definitely the stiffest defensive competition I think the Bengals forwards have seen this season. One thing I'll give the Bengals credit for, they are not even the slightest bit intimidated by them. They're pinning their ears back and going at them. I would like to see, I don't want to see the Bengals get away from their skill. I mean, Guerrera and Gallivan have the stat lines they have because of how much skill they possess. But you'd like to see simpler hockey, more passing, better shots, instead of trying to skate through the whole team and trying to make it look pretty, because this is a game, especially, where it doesn't matter how, but it's how many.
And we are underway in second period play as Buffalo State coming out with possession in the offensive zone very quickly. Shot taken from the right point by Ryan Hahn. Rebound opportunity there in front. Second save made on the play by Shea Grant. Puck down low now. Zach Schultz looking to start something there below the net, as Christian Kukas chips it out along the far wall. Bengals keeping it in, though, with Elliott Hunt just along the blue line there, as now Tampa comes back through the neutral zone. Shot taken going wide. And now coming out the near side, Anton Rupert with an opportunity to get it out of the zone, carrying it through center ice, losing control of it right below our broadcast position. Ryan Hahn in the far corner picking it up, chips a pass through the neutral zone, doesn't actually get past the blue line, kept in on the play by Tampa, but Hahn gets the puck back. Now with a second opportunity to get it out, ends up just clearing it the length of the ice, and that's going to go for icing on the play, as Cole Newman unable to win the foot race there with the Tampa player.
Ryan Hahn's head went right up to the ceiling after that pass, because he was just a touch off right there and it led to an icing. But the Bengals are coming out, they're pedal to the metal right here. They're in full-blown attack mode trying to get that first goal right here.
Face off to the right of the goaltender A.J. White. Puck comes out to the far boards now. Zach Schultz tries to chip it along and ends up going off the glass and through the neutral zone back into Tampa territory. Josie Davis now chasing it back down for Tampa. Davis in behind his own net, carrying it now across his own blue line and through the neutral zone. Davis one on three here as the two Bengals players stand him up. The puck ends up behind the Bengals net. William Cody there along the Zamboni door, winning possession of that loose puck from Cole Newman. And he sends it back down low, but it's going to be Ryan Kelly picking it up there, but he loses control of it as Ryan Murray looks to feed a pass out in front. Loose puck there in the slot. Shot didn't get through traffic, though, as it was bouncing a little bit there in the Tampa player. Murray's shot attempt from the perimeter hits a pad and doesn't get through. Murray then feeds it back down low, where he's got Ryan Andrews. Shot then taken from the outside there along the hash marks, goes wide and ends up coming through the neutral zone all the way back into Tampa territory. And setting it up there is the goaltender Shea Grant. Over to the far side, Josie Davis now looking for it, goes off a skate, almost comes right out in front. Goaltender Grant sharp there to make sure that he didn't let that puck get out in front of the net with any danger there, as the puck now comes back down into Buff State territory, and some good pressure being put on by Andrews for Tampa. Andrews with a man on him, feeds the pass down low. He's got a man there, and it's McMahon. Get it back to the point. Shot comes through traffic, but it hits Ryan Kelly on the way through. Good shot block there to keep that one from getting in on net. Gallivan then getting the puck out of the zone. Almost an opportunity to get it past the defenseman and maybe have a little bit of a break. Glasgow now catching the pass along his own blue line. Sidesteps a checker, gets it into the offensive zone, tries to feed a backhand pass, but he gets it right back on his stick, and he loses control of it as McMahon, with a good defensive play, came in from behind and lifted the stick and took it off of Glasgow there. Ryan Kelly in his own zone, making a good play to come up with the loose puck, then sending it through the neutral zone. As it goes in behind the Tampa net, no icing on the play as the Tampa player had a chance to play it. Gallivan now in the offensive end, looking to make something happen, feeds it down low, tries to get that cycle play working as Guerrera now in with some pressure, but Tampa clears the zone, gets it into center ice, and Alex Hussey starts it up for the Bengals. Hussey to Brennan. Brennan's pass doesn't connect, and that allows Parrish to dump it back in for Tampa. And Alex Hussey chasing it down there in the far corner, taking a hit up against the Zamboni door, but the Bengals do manage to start their breakout, getting it into the neutral zone. Guerrera now carrying it in across the blue line. Guerrera losing control of that one. Good play there by the defenseman to get him off of that puck. But Guerrera now coming back in the opposite direction yet again. Gets it to Sardina. Sardina in across the blue line, takes a hit, but gets it into the near corner. Guerrera then banks it off the side of the net. Shot, then an attempt as Sardina had that puck come right out to him, right around the dot. Good shot in on goal and a good pad save made by Shea Grant.
Might have been Shea Grant's best save of the day. And the reason it was such a great save is because how easy it looked. He easily, and nobody even would have blamed him, if he came off that post even an inch, that puck finds the back of the net and he stays firm on it and keeps that puck out of the net. That's a sneaky little shot there by Sardina.
Especially with that play changing direction so quickly with the puck hitting the outside of the net. Grant had to be good to keep his angles there and not overcommit in one direction or another. Shot taken there by Gallivan, goes wide, kept in on the play by Branca. Branca taking a hit on the far wall, but he keeps it moving. Puck comes back to the point, picking it up there. It's Ryan Miller. Miller letting a high shot go. It goes over top of the crossbar and then hits the glass in behind the net. Alex Hussey doing some good work here to keep it in, but two different Tampa players do manage to get it out into the neutral zone. Ryan Miller now picking it up, trying to start the breakout. Fans on a pass. That gives Tampa a chance to counter in the other direction. Bringing it in on goal, taking the shot and beating the goaltender is going to be Aldridge. Augustin Aldridge getting the goal here as he found that loose puck right off the turnover, took the shot right in off the far post and in. It's now 1-0 Tampa, as it looked like, as you were saying, Ryan Miller had a little bit of an argument with the official. I couldn't quite tell what happened there behind the play, Sean.
He was trying to skate the puck out of the zone and he collided with a forward and lost the puck. And then on his way down, he took out another Bengals forward. So Alex Hussey kind of got stuck on an island by himself. Number 18, Aldridge, just had all day to pick his spot, and he put it right below the blocker of A.J. White and inside the far post.
So at 4:33 of the second period, we have our first goal on the board, and it's the University of Tampa breaking the ice and getting the game's first one here tonight. Tampa now leading 1-0 with 15 minutes and 15 seconds to go in the period. Puck in the neutral zone now, as it's going to be Stephen Buck carrying it into the offensive end for Tampa. Gets it to the goal scorer, and the goal scorer actually getting that shot right in on goal, as Aldridge had a little bit of a knuckler in on White. White had a bit of a difficulty handling that shot, but he did manage to make the save. Has to make another one there. Now a rebound sitting loose in the front, and it's going to be Stephen Buck getting that shot in on goal. Bengals do manage to clear the zone, getting it all the way back into Tampa territory. Bengals now putting some pressure on in the offensive zone as Elliott Hunt tried to make a pass there. Got intercepted. That creates a breakaway opportunity. Murray in alone. Murray with the shot in on goal, saved by White, but the rebound opportunity is put home. And now it's a 2-0 lead for the Tampa Spartans. Ryan Andrews pouncing on that loose puck, getting the rebound goal, giving Tampa the 2-0 lead.
Not really sure what the Bengals were doing down low right there. The puck kind of like they chipped it forward ahead, and then they all rushed the puck and just left a forward, number 61, Murray, in alone. Hahn does a great job back-checking, and White makes the initial save, but when he went for the poke check and missed, the puck was sitting on the doorstep, and the Spartans had a wide-open net to make it 2-0.
Bengals in a little bit of a hole here as the first two goals of the game scored by the Tampa Spartans. It's a 2-0 lead for Tampa. As the Bengals look to answer here, as Sardina brings it into the offensive zone. Pass back to Guerrera, shot in on goal, rebound sitting there. Unable to pick it up, though, on that first opportunity, but Gallivan now with the chance to get that second rebound. But Tampa does manage to clear the zone after that scramble in front of the net.
Good response by the Bengals after giving up that second goal, going right for the net and just crowding the crease, looking for that bounce. They always say, if you get a greasy one, it can open the floodgates.
First Tampa goal scored by number 18, Augustin Aldridge. Assists for number 12, Stephen Buck, and number 29, Jake Courant. Aldridge from Buck and Courant. Time of the first Tampa goal, 4:33. Second Tampa goal scored by number 2, Ryan Andrews. Assist to number 9, William Cody, and number 61, Ryan Murray. Andrews from Cody and Murray. Time of the second Tampa goal, 5:29. Face off in the Bengals zone here as it comes out to Guerrera right off the draw. Guerrera with a chance to carry it into the neutral zone, get it into the offensive end. But it's going to be Tampa finding possession of it just inside their own blue line. Parrish fires a backhander towards the Buff State bench. It ends up right into the Buff State bench. And backup goaltender Anthony Kowalski tosses it back to the linesman. And now the faceoff will come in the offensive zone for the Bengals coming up here with 13:35 to go in the second period.
Bengals really, really need to get some possession, zone time, and get some shots on goal. They are big time on their heels, down 2-0 right now. Another goal, this could get blown open early, so the Bengals really, really need to press to get that next goal.
McMahon with the puck and ahead of steam through the neutral zone. Miller on him, ends up on his stomach making the play, but the puck comes back to the point, and it's kept in by the defenseman Sacco. Sacco's shot goes just wide, but Catalina's there for Tampa to pick it up and keep it moving down low. Catalina gets it to Parrish, who moves it back to Catalina. Now back out to the point. Shot taken there. Goes off the side of the net. And Jolo Tempio picks it up in the near corner. He has two different Tampa players on him, but feeds it around behind the net where he's got Ryan Miller. Miller chips it along the boards where he's got Glasgow in the neutral zone. Glasgow up to Newman. Newman tries to dump it in, but he can't get it past the defenseman, and Tampa quickly counters in the other direction. But that pass goes too far for its intended target. Now the Bengals with a chance to get it into the offensive zone as it's gulfed in by John Glasgow. 12:44 to go here in second period play as Tampa clears the zone, quickly sent right back in by Adam Brennan. Picking it up there in the corner is going to be Cameron Sacco. Sacco slowly now making a pass through the middle of the zone, connects on that pass and carrying it out of the zone and into Buff State territory of the Tampa Spartans, but they lose control of it. And now Captain Jolo Tempio back in the opposite direction. Pucky is tangled up in a couple of the players there just to the left of the Bengals bench. Three different Bengals in there trying to come out with that loose puck. And it's going to be Zach Schultz with the first chance to do so, but it's going to come back to Joe Lotempio, and Lotempio feeds it down low to Schultz. Schultz with a man on him. Lotempio slides in to get some support on the play, but coming out of there with that puck is going to be McDonald for Tampa. Floats it through the neutral zone, then it's kicked into the offensive zone for Tampa. They have to be careful not to touch up and get an offsides on that play. But a chance to get a puck up ice is just unsuccessful in making that pass as it couldn't stay flat on the ice. And Anton Rupert unable to make connection on that pass. So that results in an icing and another faceoff back in the Bengals territory.
Bengals can't even buy a bounce right now either. All the passing is just a touch off. Every time they look to make a breakout, Tampa's getting a stick in the lane. Bengals just need to continue just putting their nose to the grindstone and keep working at this. They have plenty of time left, but they got to get moving to try and get that first goal and then get back into this game.
Rupert and Hoffberg on the draw to the blocker side of A.J. White. Another false start there on the draw, however.
How many times do we have to drop this? I didn't see what was wrong either time.
Looked like the linesman didn't like it the first time, and then the official didn't like it. The referee didn't like it the second time. Hopefully we can get the third attempt successful here on this faceoff.
Is there anyone else left not to like it? All right, good.
All right, now we have a successful faceoff, and the Bengals can't manage to clear the zone, though. Kukis winding up with a huge slap shot there that couldn't get it through traffic. Puck in behind the Bengals net now, comes out to Hoffberg. Hoffberg looking to set something up, back to the point to Pettijohn. Pettijohn low shot through traffic, pad save made by A.J. White. Hoffberg back to the point to Pettijohn. Tampa doing a good job setting it up. Good deflection shot in on goal. White had to be sharp to make that stop. Cross ice pass just doesn't connect with Hoffberg, but he catches it off the boards, feeds it again down low. As it's going to be Aldridge there in the corner. Aldridge gets it back to the point. Pettijohn goes cross ice. Slap shot taken by Kukis. Great pad save on the one-timer there by A.J. White. Bengals having a little bit of difficulty getting it out. They do manage to clear the zone as John Glasgow goes cross ice off the boards in the neutral zone. And the goaltender for Tampa with a bit of a dangerous play there trying to make the pass. We had Zach Schultz right in his face. Ends up with the puck on his stick. He just sets it up for his defenseman this time, but it ends up as a bit of a breakaway pass for Murray again. Murray in alone, save made as Ryan Hahn got over there quickly to make sure that he didn't have that opportunity. Going to get a penalty called on him, though, as Murray ended up spilling into the net. Bengals just a little bit sloppy there with their neutral zone coverage there as Murray got in behind the defense. And Hahn coming back late on that play ended up taking the penalty to negate the scoring opportunity. So Tampa now with the 2-0 lead. They're going to get a chance on the power play here as Hahn heads to the box.
Bengals really, really cannot afford to lose that man like that. He was standing there for a few seconds. I mean, he was camping on that blue line for a while. got in, got a shot. And then to just rub salt in the wound, Han takes a penalty, so they're going to be down one of their better penalty killers. And an absolutely, I mean, this is a must kill to say the least, though the Bengals really, really would like to try to get one of their patented shorthanded goals. It's going to be a little tougher to do that without him on the ice, though.
Buffalo State penalty to number 22, Ryan Han. 2 minutes for hooking. Han, 2 minutes for hooking. Time of the penalty, 9:20. Tampa setting it up in the offensive zone now on their power play. Shot attempt doesn't get through traffic. Bengals with a chance to clear the zone. Bouncing puck. Sardina does manage to get it out into the neutral zone. Pettijohn with Hunt on him. Circling back into his own end. Setting up behind his own net. Looking to start their power play breakout. Sets it up for McMahon. McMahon changing directions in his own zone. Has a little bit of room now through the neutral zone. McMahon across the blue line. Lets a shot go. Glove save made by A.J. White. White just hangs on to that one, forces a stoppage in play. 10:03 remaining in the second period. It is a 2-0 lead for Tampa, and they have a minute 23 remaining on their power play.
That shot was moving, too. That was a really, really, really quick glove by A.J. White, seeing that through a screen. That puck was labeled for the top corner. Nice glove there by A.J. White.
Bengals winning the draw here on the penalty kill as Adam Brennan tries to pin it up against the boards here in the near corner. Sardina now on the puck in the far corner, managed to get it away from one Tampa player, but the Spartans keep it in. Josie Davis gets it down low to Hoffberg. Hoffberg looking to set it up as the Bengals are running around a little bit in their own zone. Shot taken there from the far side as only two Tampa players were over there. Kukis letting that shot in on goal. A.J. White making a solid stop there and smartly covering it up, making sure there was no rebound.
Yeah, because there's a rebound right there. The Bengals were just, they were all over the place except for near the puck. I mean, there were two Tampa players all alone. A.J. White had to swallow that just so the Bengals could just calm down because they are just running around the zone right now, and Tampa is just putting every pass on the tape.
Minute now remaining in the Tampa power play as Buck takes a shot from the midpoint, doesn't get through a couple of bodies that were there in front of the net. Comes out to the far corner as two players for Tampa try to dig that puck out of there, but it's going to be Ryan Kelly digging it out and firing it in behind the net. Tampa, though, finding possession of it. It's going to be Parrish below the goal line. Feeds a pass back to Josie Davis, who pivots at the point. Now back to Parrish. Parrish with a little bit of room there. Back to the midpoint. Davis's shot through traffic. Glove save made by White. White hangs on yet again. Faceoff will be coming up again in the Tampa offensive zone. 30 seconds remaining in their power play.
A.J. White's keeping him in it right now, Aaron. That's two really nice saves and no rebound, which is the one thing we've known about A.J. since he got here. When the puck hits him, it usually sticks to him, and that is going to be paramount in this game with who they're playing and how the Spartans are playing today as well.
Tampa getting possession off the draw as they still have 20-plus seconds remaining on their power play. The puck hits the linesman. Now an opportunity for Gallivan through the neutral zone. Has a half step on the Spartans players. Gets a backhand shot in on goal. And the save's made by Grant. Grant quickly drops it, keeps the play moving. Some good back pressure there from the Tampa players, making sure that Gallivan did not get that full step on the defenders and get that opportunity on the penalty kill. Bengals do manage to kill off the penalty, though, as going back to the bench is Ryan Han. Cole Newman joining the play for the Bengals as Guerrera digs the puck out of the corner. Guerrera now looking for that long pass to Newman in the neutral zone. That one doesn't connect as Josie Davis got in the way. And now Davis in the offensive zone. Unfortunately for him, though, and Tampa supporters, he was just offsides. And that'll result in a faceoff just in front of our broadcast position with 8:25 to go in the second period. It is a 2-0 Tampa lead.
Big kill there by the Bengals right there. And you got to tip your cap there to A.J. White specifically, keeping it a 2-0 game with some big saves. Bengals survived a storm right there so they can get back to their game. And they still have, you know, a little less than half a period to get back in it. We're far from done here, but the Bengals really got to kick it into gear.
Next goal's big in this one, Sean, I'd have to think.
Yes.
Loose puck in front of the net. Chipped up to Glasgow by Kelly, and now Glasgow gets it up to Lotempio in the neutral zone. Unable to keep it moving there and get it across the blue line, and now Courant back in the opposite direction for Tampa. Courant fakes the shot, tries to get around Brennan, losing control of it there. Now it's in the near corner. Slid in behind the net as DiGiorgio's there for Tampa. Feeds it along to Evans. Evans tries to look for a passing lane in front. Doesn't see one, so he carries it around behind the net, then feeds a pass back to the point. That shot through traffic. I'm not sure that White ever saw it, but his positioning was proper, and he made the pad save, covered up that rebound. And now we'll have another faceoff coming up in the Bengals zone with 7:47 to go in the period. Bengals need a response here, Sean. It's been a lot of Tampa since they got their two goals.
Yes, it's been pretty much all Tampa, minus the partial break there by Gallivan. And A.J. White, I don't think he saw that puck. I think he just felt it. It hit him on the foot. And just instinctually, White just dropped into his butterfly and was able to find it. before any of the Tampa forwards could vulture that puck into the net.
Shot blocked there by the Bengals as they look to stretch it through the neutral zone again. That play has been unsuccessful throughout this game. Bengals would probably be wiser to try to make shorter passes to break this defensive pressure from the Spartans. Puck is dumped in deep by the Spartans as they look to make a play from in behind the net, but Ryan Kelly gets in the way. Circles there in the far corner. His pass goes off a Tampa player, and now he's got two men pressuring him in the far corner. Coming out with it is Ryan Andrews, the most recent goal scorer for the Tampa Spartans. Gets it back to the point. Kept in on the play by the Spartans, and Andrews has it again on his stick. Hard cross-ice pass right on the tape, and then it goes high and up over the net as that shot was taken there from the right point by McDonald. Tampa keeping the pressure on here in the offensive zone here. Murray tries to feed a pass out in front. Hit a couple of different bodies there. Didn't quite get onto the tape of any of the Tampa players. And then ends up in the neutral zone as Tampa looks to regroup and send it back into their offensive territory. Cole Newman, though, gets in the way of a pass. Sends it deep into the offensive zone. Shea Grant looks to start the breakout for the Spartans there and gets it into the neutral zone. Puck just below our broadcast position as McMahon comes up with the loose puck, gives it to McDonald, and then McDonald floats one high into the rafters, ends up catching one of the beams, and that will result in a stoppage in play and most likely a faceoff in the neutral zone. 6:31 remaining in second period play. Tampa still leading this one by a 2-0 score, and our coverage is brought to you by Town Auto. For over 50 years, a proud member of the Western New York community, putting customers' needs first and helping them find the right car at the right price. The dealerships of Town Auto make buying a car easy, whether online, over the phone, or in store. We love our town. It's going to be an offensive zone faceoff as the Tampa player flipped it into the rafters, but they could get a breakaway out of it as the long floating pass through the neutral zone. Great save by A.J. White as the player came in all alone. Frank Catalina picking up that long flip pass from Josie Davis right off that faceoff. Clearly a set play and not one the Bengals were ready for.
No, that's the second time Hahn's been beaten by that. Just the forward just sneaking off to his side and then cutting up the middle. Got him again on that. A.J. White again standing tall in his net, making the saves. I mean, if the Bengals are able to get back into this game, A.J. White is going to be every reason why, because he has kept this game from being a blowout. He really has.
A little bit of a false start again on the draw, but we hopefully are ready to go, but we're not ready.
Or what?
There's a whistle there. See, I don't know if it came from above the ref or if he blew it himself. Confused me a little bit, but we are underway yet again as the puck is dumped into the Buff State zone. 6:09 remaining here in the second period. Ryan Miller coming out of the far corner with a head of steam, carrying the puck out of his own zone. Gets as far as the Tampa blue line, but quickly countering. Here come the Spartans. Catalina bringing into the offensive zone. Rips a hard shot low, and he beats the goaltender White. It's now 3-0 Spartans.
Ryan Miller's upset again. But right there, I mean, Ryan Miller tries to carry the puck through three guys, loses it, and then he goes forward while the Spartans just pick the puck right off his stick and go back the other way while the defenseman's caught no man's land. And again, A.J. White gets beat by a low blocker shot because the forward, number 10, Catalina, just had all day and half the night to pick his spot. Like we said at the end of the first, you are not going to skate through this team. Like, it's not going to happen, and the Bengals keep trying to do it, and now they're trying to add the stretch pass, and Tampa's just sitting there waiting for it, and they're taking it.
And to make matters worse, Ryan Miller took a penalty at the end of all that. Ryan Miller taking 2 minutes, not sure exactly what the call is going to be. An elbowing call is what the note that we have gotten here is. So the Bengals certainly in a hole right now. 5:56 remaining here in the second period. It is a 3-0 Tampa lead as they have pretty much just dominated the second period, Sean.
Yeah, it's been all Tampa the entire period. The Bengals have had one, maybe two decent scoring chances, and the best one, it was a backhand that just kind of had to happen strictly for the fact that there was a back check. The Bengals have done the thing against a team like Tampa that you cannot do, and that is shoot themselves in the foot repeatedly. And it shouldn't even be as close as 3-0 the way this game has gone.
Got two penalties up on the board right now. Looks like there might have been a misconduct call as well.
Miller was arguing. Oh, it was heated at the refs. It's not crazy to think that he got one for unsportsmanlike conduct.
Apparently it's going to be a bench minor penalty on that.
So it's going to be a 5-on-3 for Tampa.
So 5-on-3 with a 3-0 lead.
Bad
this
worse.
Is definitely an opportunity to put some nails in the coffin here if you're the Tampa Spartans.
Yeah, they can put their boot on Buff State's neck right here if they want to with a 5-on-3.
Stephen Buck slowly across the blue line, allowing Tampa to set up their power play really quickly here. Back to Davis. Davis to Buck at the top of the circle. Shot in on goal, but White makes that first save. Key stop here on the penalty kill as the Bengals have a full 2 minute 5-on-3 to kill off here. Third Tampa goal scored by number 10, Frank Catalina. Assist to number 11, Grant Parrish, and number 13, Connor McMahon. Catalina from Parrish and McMahon. Time of the goal, 14:04. Buffalo State penalty to number 16, Ryan Miller, 2 minutes for elbowing. Miller, 2 minutes for elbowing. Also a bench minor to Buffalo State, being served by number 93, Mark Hager. Time of the penalties, 14:04. Minute 12 remaining in the 5-on-3 as the shot's taken from Parrish from a prime spot. Great pay-it save made by A.J. White. White has certainly been the best player in black and orange here this evening, keeping his team within this three-goal margin right now.
Yeah, he's been the only Bengal that brought it tonight, Aaron. He's playing outstanding and has been the best player for them. It's not even really close.
Puck here at the near point. Josie Davis slowing things down, setting it up, getting it down low to Hoffberg. Hoffberg with a man on him, feeds it around behind the net. Puck is then fed back to the point, settled down by Kukis. Kukis gets it across, now to Buck. Buck with a man on him, a little bit of difficulty getting that cross ice pass. Now Bengals with a 2-on-1 here. Ryan Kelly carrying it in, he's got Hunt with him. Lets the shot go, but a save made on that play as Shea Grant got the blocker on it, but the rebound opportunity came out to Hunt. Looked like he had a pass, had an opportunity to get that one past him. But now the Tampa Spartans have some numbers here as Ryan Murray gets it into the offensive zone. Didn't quite work out for those numbers as the Bengals got back on defense and set it up here, but the Tampa Spartans still looking to make something happen with 8 seconds remaining on their two-man advantage. Puck comes out to Murray, wide open opportunity, just can't hit the net, fired it up high. Penalty finally expires, Bengals back to even strength here. Andrews with an opportunity, rebound shot as it came right out in front. That one's going to be waved off. The official right there on the spot waves off that goal. Tampa players are still celebrating, but it's quickly waved off, I believe. He looked like he waved it off and then he pointed at center ice.
I don't get what's happening here.
No goal. He's definitely waved it off as no goal. But I'm not sure exactly what the explanation is for it. Because he pointed back to center ice, so I was trying to figure out exactly what that meant. The key point to take away from this, though, is it's still a 3-0 game. The goal was waved off. I'm not sure why.
The only thing I can think of is goaltender interference, because that was a beautiful job to tipping the puck in front of the net there by number 2 Ryan Andrews. I mean, that was a really nice play by him. I can't imagine he kicked it. I mean, he might have, but from where I was sitting, everything looked good there. You know, puck, unfortunate bounce for the Bengals, but Ryan Andrews was right there to tip it in.
Ends up being a fortunate break for the Bengals, though, that the goal ends up being waved off.
Well, they needed that.
And the faceoff's going to come out here in the neutral zone. So with 3:50 to go now here in second period action, still a 3-0 Tampa lead as the Bengals try to mount a charge here to chip back away at this three-goal lead. Puck comes out to Newman. Newman banks it off the boards, gets it into the neutral zone, but Tampa picking up with possession. Pass intercepted by Miller, carrying it in the offensive zone. Gets around one man, gets it in on goal, but he was unable to find control of that puck after getting around the one player. Looks like he might be in a little bit of discomfort there as well.
He's
reaching for his collarbone shoulder area. I think he should be okay. He's staying on the ice. Certainly seems to be in enough level of comfort to continue going on his shift here. Tampa winning the draw, and Miller quickly over there to the far point to keep it in. Tampa now trying to break it up the near side. Good stick handling and passing there as DiGiorgio carries it into the offensive zone. DiGiorgio getting wide, tries to feed a pass in front, hits off a Bengal defender. Now the Bengals with a chance to carry it out up the near side. Joe Lotempio with it. Lotempio one-hands it into the neutral zone. Tampa coming away with possession after that and sending it back into the offensive end. Adam Brennan has to restart the breakout. Brennan to Lotempio. Lotempio around behind the net where he's got Ryan Miller. That pass doesn't get out of the zone, no, and Tampa keeping it in with 2:55 to go in the second. Courant getting it down low, and he's got Aldridge down there. Bengals try to reverse course and break it out up the far side. Glasgow getting it into the neutral zone with a high flip pass, and quickly on that one is Joe Lotempio. Lotempio tried to dig it out of his skates and get a shot in on goal. Ended up colliding with the goaltender a little bit there. Both of them ending up on the ice at the end of that play. Ryan Hahn back in his own zone, tries to chip it into the neutral zone, hits a Tampa player, and they have to clear in order to avoid any offsides. Gives the Bengals a little bit of time and space to break it out. Ryan Hahn doing so, trying to get that pass through. Unfortunately, it's intercepted. Now a 3-on-1 developing here for Tampa. Just couldn't get that pass flat on the ice, as that would have been a pretty nice scoring opportunity for Buck on the back door. Pass was just up off the ice a little bit and then ended up going out of play. And we're going to have a faceoff with 2:11 to go in second period play. It's still a 3-0 lead for the Tampa Spartans.
Yeah, the Bengals continuing to be their own worst enemy right here. Just turnovers in the neutral zone against a very fast team, a very good passing team. That's gonna be danger every time. Bengals really have to clean it up. They have to do it now if they're going to have any chance of getting back into this game.
Bengals had been a very good second period team throughout this season up until this weekend. They had actually won every second period throughout the season, and the closest one that they had was a 3-1 count, which they had four different times. However, they lost the second period last night to Central Florida. They're down 3-0 in this period to Tampa, and they're going to have to do something to stop the flow of momentum in this game and do it quickly. Minute 43 to go here in second period play. Elliott Hunt intercepting a pass, getting it moving in the offensive zone. Kept in by Rupert, but Rupert losing control. And that gives Tampa a chance to break it out with Stephen Buck. Buck taking a hit there from Hunt in front of the Buff State bench, but Hoffberg finds the loose puck and dumps it deep into the Buff State territory. Alex Hussey chasing it down and starting the breakout up the near side. Gets it up to Rupert. Rupert digs that pass out of his skates and now carries it into the center of the ice. Gets away from one man and then gains the offensive zone, taking it wide and behind the net. Anton Rupert feeds that pass in front. He's got Elliott Hunt there, just couldn't quite manage to corral that pass. And the puck comes out into the neutral zone as Tampa manages to break it out. Good back check there by Zach Schultz as he took the puck off at his man's stick there, but he lost control in his own zone. Now it's deep in the Buff State territory as Andrews sets up the forecheck pressure. Hussey finding control of a loose puck, gets it to Schultz with 50 seconds to go in the period. Schultz sending that pass up the far boards, goes off the boards and into Tampa territory where Kukas picks it up. Kukas's pass doesn't connect with Murray, and that allows the Bengals to regroup and start the breakout up the far side, but Kelly taking a hit there from behind. It's going to be a penalty coming up to Tampa as a couple different Buff State players went against the offending player. I don't know if they got the retaliation. I think they might have.
They went at the bench, so that would be an absolute just, I don't even know what to even call it if the Bengals took a penalty after they're about to be gifted a power play to get back into this game.
Well, there's a conversation going on between the official and then Guerrera and Gallivan. I don't know if they got one of them for a retaliation. The original penalty was called pretty quickly by the official in the neutral zone. The check from behind. And we'll have to see whether or not there's a second call here on this one. As with 33 seconds to go in the period, there's a big conversation now going on with the three officials, as well as five different players, three from the Buff State side and two Tampa Spartans in there. We'll have to wait and see what we see from the scorer's box.
Guerrero's not happy, so.
Maybe he was lobbying for a five. That might be the only thing I can think of. No, Gallivan got a penalty.
Not only does that hurts for two reasons. One, because you just negated a power play, but now one of your best offensive players is in the box because he decided to take a run at the bench when his team was going to get a penalty. That's just not good. It's just not something you can afford to be doing right now when you're playing a team that has the depth and firepower these Spartans have. I mean, Tampa hasn't made any mistakes, and then they just made one, and the Bengals gave it back to him immediately.
It would have been a much-needed power play for the Bengals there, as this period has been just dominated by the Tampa Spartans. They've gotten all three of the goals in the period. They've spent most of the time camped out in A.J. White's zone. And the last 33 seconds of this period, it looks like will be played 4-on-4. Still awaiting exact word on what those penalties were. But the faceoff's going to be in the neutral zone in front of the Buff State bench. Outside of the Tampa zone.
So, yep, 4-on-4.
And some firepower out there from the Bengals. It's Sardina with Guerrera, Kelly, and Brennan. Bengals going to try to get a one last push here in the second period, try to create another scoring opportunity before the end of the first 40 minutes here tonight.
If you get one here, Aaron, I don't know, but there's just something about needing two in a third period versus three that just sounds a lot less daunting.
almost a quick breakaway pass as that play almost got developed again by the Tampa Spartans as their man quickly got up ice and was behind the Buff State defense. They just couldn't connect on that pass. Shot taken from the point there by Cukis goes wide. Now the Bengals with a chance to break it out. Guerrera carries it over his own blue line, gets it through the neutral zone. He's got a man right on his back, but he gets it into the offensive end, gets a shot in on goal. Save made by Grant. Guerrera with it again with a chance with a wraparound. Grant making another save with just 2 seconds left in the period. Puck comes out into center ice, and the horn goes to end the period. Buff State with a little bit of a push there at the end. Unable to get anything from that push, however, and the period will end with the score 3-0 in favor of Tampa.
Yeah, there was nothing to like in that period for the Bengals. I hate to be candid, but that is what it is. I mean, you gave up 3 goals. You of the 20 minutes in the period, I would if the over-under was set at 10 minutes of zone time for Tampa, I'm going to hammer that over because that felt like Tampa was on the power play the entire period. And then the Bengals just continued to just kill themselves with poor passing, icing the puck, and then they were given a power play and gave it back before the ref even had his arm all the way up in the air. So they're lucky it's only 3, and they're lucky. And the thing about it is the Bengals, if there's any team that's capable of putting up 3 quickly, it's these Bengals, but now they have to do it. So let's see if they can do it. They've been able to do it when they didn't have to do it. Now you got to do it, and you're facing a goalie that's 5-0. So you want a test? Here you go.
Certainly is a test in front of the Bengals here for this third period of play. After 40 minutes of play, it is a 3-0 Tampa lead. And support for our coverage of Buff State Club Hockey comes from Militello Realty, Western New York's premier commercial real estate broker. To buy, sell, or lease any office, industrial, retail, or investment property, trust the unparalleled knowledge and experience of Militello Realty. Online, militello.com. Supporters also include Ivy Lee Pharmacy, a locally owned neighborhood pharmacy for over 60 years. If you're traveling to Canada, Ivy Lee has PCR COVID tests available with a quick one-hour turnaround. Ivy Lee Pharmacy at 2446 Elmwood Avenue in Kenmore. Our coverage also brought to you by Town Auto. For over 50 years, a proud member of the Western New York community, putting customers' needs first and helping them find the right car at the right price. The dealerships of Town Auto make buying a car easy, whether online, over the phone, or in store. We love our town. Supporters also include the Hurdle Parker Liquor Store. With everyday low prices on a great selection of wines and spirits, the Hurdle Parker Liquor Store on the corner of Hurdle and Parker in North Buffalo. Our supporters also include the law offices of Nicholas J. Narchis, an advocate for Western New Yorkers with blue-collar roots, providing efficient and cost-effective representation from offices in Lockport and Geneseo, online, narchislaw.com. And our supporters also include 95 Nutrition, healthy and delicious meal prep and delivery, making it simple to live a healthy lifestyle and reach your nutritional goals. Enjoy the convenience of healthy eating with 95 Nutrition. More information, 95nutrition.com. And finally, Envious Gamewear, the official uniform supplier of Buffalo State Club Hockey, making high-end custom team uniforms, bags, and apparel. Online, enviousgamewear.com. So our score after 20 minutes of play, it's 3-0 Tampa. We're going to take a short break here and rejoin you for third period coverage momentarily. Thank you.
2 minutes for checking from behind and 10-minute misconduct. The 2 minute penalty will be served by number 22, Gavin McDonald. Buffalo State penalty to number 8, Ben Gallivan, 2 minutes for roughing. Andrews, 2 minutes for checking from behind and a 10-minute misconduct. Gallivan, 2 minutes for roughing. Final penalties, 19:27 of the second period. And we're about set for third period action here from the Buffalo State Ice Arena.
Sorry about that. We're about set for third period action from the Buffalo State Ice Arena as the puck is dropped and we are underway here in the third. Aaron Alpern alongside Sean McHugh bringing you the call of this evening's game. And the Bengals have possession of the puck right off the faceoff. Getting into the offensive zone was Ryan Miller, unable to handle it and keep control of that puck, however, as Pettijohn took it off of his stick and starts it back out for Tampa. Stephen Buck through the neutral zone across the blue line. Playing 4-on-4 here as those penalties still continuing from late in the second period. Puck comes back to the point to Kukis. He lets a shot go, but it goes just wide. Kept in by Pettijohn at the far point. Pass is intercepted by Ryan Miller. Miller reverses course, and now the Bengals have a little bit of room to work as Ryan Miller sends a pass far through the neutral zone. Ends up getting a little bit of help with a bank off the boards. It comes out to Sardina. Sardina then tried to feed it out in front. Just couldn't quite connect with Zach Schultz. Pass is intercepted there as Ryan Hahn stepped into that passing lane, then fires a shot well wide of the net, off the glass and out of the zone, back into Buffalo State territory. Adam Brennan has to chase it down there with a man on him. Tampa coming out with possession of that puck as Cody looks to make something happen. Cody with the puck along the goal line has plenty of time to do something, fires that shot in on goal. Eventually, A.J. White just had to make that save to stop that opportunity. 15 seconds now remaining in the coincidental penalties as Ryan Murray with a chance to carry it through the neutral zone for Tampa. 1-on-2 as he stops and tries to create some more room for himself. Chips a pass along the blue line to Jake Thane. Thane dumping it in deep for Tampa as the penalties expire. Carried in from behind the net by Cody. He's got all the time in the world there to decide what he wants to do with it. Just feeds it back to the point. As the pressure is kept on here, Josie Davis letting a shot go. Gets deflected late. Ends up going wide into the corner. Tampa keeping control of the puck here across to Davis. Davis has all the time in the world. Just feeds that pass across to Murray. Unfortunately for him, he couldn't quite get a hold of it as well as he would have liked to. Guerrera now with a chance to bring it out for the Bengals. Gets it to Gallivan. Gallivan trying to get it back to Guerrera, but it goes into the far corner. Guerrera's attempted pass to Gallivan gets intercepted. Now Tampa with a chance to break it out into the neutral zone. And now with some speed, it's going to be McMahon. McMahon in on goal. Another save made by A.J. White as the offensive player, Connor McMahon, did a really nice job of getting himself free of the Buff State defenseman and getting himself alone in on the goalie, getting himself a great scoring opportunity. But a good save made by A.J. White to keep this a 3-0 game. Sean, Tampa starting where they ended off in the second period.
Yep, Bengals are trying to hit him with speed, and Tampa is just swinging right back. The Bengals, again, having difficulty connecting on those passes. They look like they're rushed, and they look like they're pressing. This feels a lot like that tournament in Rochester against Centripetal. Here we go.
Ryan Miller in alone gets in behind the defense, but a great save as number one Shea Grant faces his biggest test of the night, and he stands up to it very nicely, making the glove save and holding on for a whistle. 17:38 now left in the third. Tampa still out in front with the commanding 3-0 lead.
Good to see the Bengals, though, with the pedal to the metal right there. That was the time the breakout worked, and they got a good scoring chance. You want to get as many of those as you can against anybody, but when you're playing a guy like Shea Grant and you need three on him, you need all of those. You got to finish the next one, though.
Ooh, that was a good opportunity as it ended up getting deflected in front of the net. Goaltender lost sight of where it went and ended up hitting off the top of the cage before going behind it. Bengals with possession of it. Ryan Hahn looking to mount a charge here up the near side. Dumps it in softly into the offensive zone. Chasing it down that back there behind the net is Cameron Sacco. A little bit of an errant pass there on the far side, but they get away with it as Courant carries it through the neutral zone. Courant losing control of that puck into the Bengals' end. Feeds it in front, though, as that pass is intercepted by Alex Militello. Militello tries to get it up to Elliott Hunt in the neutral zone, but that pass is intercepted, brought back in by Evans.
Militello just got crushed and there was no call.
Actually, it looks like the back official
did blow
the play dead. I'm not sure if he's making a call here. I didn't see exactly what happened myself, but Alex Militello's on one knee just inside the Buff State blue line, clearly in a lot of discomfort.
Well, former Bengal Elliot Spitzer down there in the crowd jumped up to check on his former teammate right there. I mean, Militello ate a face full of glass right there on that drive-by, and it looks like there's going to be no call. It looks like it's just they're going to blow it dead for an injury. They're calling the trainer to him.
Yeah, Militello's still struggling to get back to his skates as he has Captain Joe Lotempio looking after him. The trainer comes out, and the two end up meeting halfway across the ice. Militello skating off under his own power. And he heads to the bench along with the trainer, and the faceoff will be coming up inside the Buff State zone to the blocker hand side of A.J. White. Support for Buffalo State Club Hockey comes from Town Auto. For over 50 years, a proud member of the Western New York community, putting customers' needs first and helping them find the right car at the right price. The dealerships of Town Auto make buying a car easy, whether online, over the phone, or in store. We love our town. Faceoff won by the Tampa Spartans. Pettijohn's shot goes wide, but it comes out back in front of the net. Now an opportunity, but A.J. White had a good close eye on where that puck was as it went up into the air. He snared it out of the air with his glove hand, holds on for a whistle, and another faceoff coming up in the offensive zone for Tampa as the Spartans make a couple of changes, get a new line out here on the ice as the faceoff is to the left of A.J. White.
A.J. White was smart. That puck was bouncing all over the place, and there were bodies crashing all around him. He just grabbed the puck and held it to avoid any potential of a bad bounce because another goal here would likely break the Bengals' backs.
Faceoff is scrambled, comes out to the far boards, and Tampa controls possession. Shot taken by Pettijohn, doesn't get through the crowd of bodies in front of the net. Comes back out to Pettijohn, though, and he looks to fire another shot in on goal. That one gets in on goal. The rebound comes out to Buck, and Buck makes no mistake, putting that rebound shot past A.J. White. It's now a 4-0 lead for the Tampa Spartans.
Tampa's just holding the puck and doing whatever they want with it right there with very little resistance. I mean, shots are getting through to the point. They're winning every puck battle. And then right there, the puck comes right to the slot, and it's just an easy tap-in right there for a 4-0 lead. Tampa brought their game today, and the Bengals are just looking to try and get something out of this because they have just been, you know, Tampa's just been working the entire game start to finish and have opened up a 4-0 lead.
Bengals now trying to respond yet again here as the Tampa Spartans are now well in command of this contest as they look to continue to add to their lead, but a pass is intercepted there in the neutral zone. Anton Rupert coming back in the opposite direction, chipping it deep into the offensive zone, chasing it down himself. Feeds a pass behind the net. He's got Galvin in the far corner. Galvin tries to feed it back to Rupert, and we're going to have a penalty called on this play, and it is an elbowing call. And it looks like it's actually going to go to Anton Rupert.
This is the stuff you can't be doing right here, Aaron. Wait.
No, he went to the bench.
Never mind, I take that back. If he did take a penalty, though, it would have been something you can't do.
It's number 8, Christian Kukas.
That's
for
big.
For the Tampa Spartans taking that penalty, the elbowing call. I thought that was what the call was, that it would have gone on Tampa, but the Bengals did have possession of the puck when the play was blown dead, so I was a touch confused about that at the moment. And then Anton Rupert looked to be skating over to the penalty box.
And angry.
And angry talking to the official. So apologies for a little bit of confusion there on that play. But the Bengals do get an opportunity here with the power play. And it is a big, much-needed opportunity with the man advantage here. John Glasgow setting it up inside the faceoff circle as he tries to feed a pass across. But that pass is intercepted. And now coming away, it's going to be Josie Davis for Tampa. Tampa trying to get that shot in on goal. Good opportunity there as the Tampa player is doing a good job of killing off some time here in this penalty. Into the offensive zone, it's Ben Gallivan. Tries to drop a pass back to the point. That gives Tampa a chance to clear the zone and get it all the way back down.
And he hooked him.
Into the Buffalo State zone, and there's going to be a penalty taken on the play as well. Well, that's going to be a tough one to come back from.
And first, he tries the fancy move on the boards, loses it, then takes a penalty. I don't know. I mean, Ben Gallivan's been great for the Bengals this season, but, I mean, this has not been one of his better games, and that's just – that's not good, and that's the second time he's done something to kill a power play today. Like, that's – you got to be better right there.
So it's going to be 4-on-4 when we get restarted here with 15:27 as Ben Gallivan takes the tripping penalty. So now we have the two October players of the month, both in the penalty box. Probably not what they were awarded the CHF Offensive and Defensive Player of the Month awards for. But nonetheless, that's where they are at the moment. As the puck gets turned over in the offensive zone, Tampa looking to create something here as they play 4-on-4. Spartans actually just killing off some time now as they send the pass all the way back into their own zone.
Refs are in the way.
Josie Davis picks it up. Yeah, I have noticed that. There have been a couple of passes that have hit some ref skates.
Josie Davis had to, like, toe drag and heel drag and dangle the ref, or else he was going to lose the puck there.
Fourth Tampa goal, scored by number 12, Stephen Buck. Assist to number 20, Michael Pettijohn, and number 89, Evan Hoffberg. Buck from Pettijohn and Hoffberg. Time of the goal, 3:35. Tampa penalty to number 8, Christian Kukis. 2 minutes for elbowing. Kukis, 2 minutes for elbowing. Time of the penalty, 3:56. Buff State penalty to number 8, Ben Gallivan. 2 minutes for tripping. Time of the Gallivan penalty for tripping, 4:07. So we finally get all the penalties read off there. And Tampa with possession inside the offensive zone. Josie Davis looking to create something there. Just ducks back out into the neutral zone as there are just 7 seconds now remaining on the original penalty here, the one to Tampa. And then they're going to have an abbreviated power play, but the puck is in the offensive zone for the Bengals right now as Davis falls on top of the puck. Joe Lotempio trying to dig it out of there, but coming out with it is going to be number 10, Frank Catalina. Catalina gets it deep into the offensive zone, tries to chase it down himself, takes a bump from Ryan Kelly. That allows Ryan Hahn a little bit of time to get it up into the neutral zone where he finds Elliot Hunt. Bengals now killing a penalty now as Hunt carries it into the offensive zone. Has some help from Joe Lotempio. The two of them supporting each other nicely there, though, but it looked like Hunt got the stick up on the Tampa player Parrish, and it's going to be another opportunity for the two-man advantage here for the Tampa Spartans as there are still 7 seconds remaining on the original Buff State penalty. And now Elliot Hunt heads to the box for a two-minute high sticking call with 13:33 to go in the period.
Seeing a lot of frustration out of the Bengals right now, Aaron. That's something we haven't seen all season right now, where they're getting really, really active with the sticks and with the after-the-play shoving, and the refs aren't having it. So Bengals have to kill another penalty down 4-0 to a team that's just been holding the puck all game.
Buffalo State penalty to number 9, Elliot Hunt. 2 minutes for high sticking. Hunt, 2 minutes for high sticking. Time of the penalty, 6:27. So the Bengals managed to kill off the first part of the two-man advantage, but it's still a minute 40 to go in the power play as it was wide open in front of the net as Parrish had a golden opportunity. A.J. White making one of his better saves of the game, and he's made a lot of very good ones throughout. Here's another opportunity as a hard wrist shot taken by Kukis. It goes wide on the nice setup on the cross ice pass from Josie Davis. Bengals now looking to kill off some time. Gallivan carries it into the offensive zone, just dumping it in. Maybe a little bit more frustration being shown by Bengals players here as you hear the sticks being slammed on the ice and the doors being slammed on the bench. As Stephen Buck carries it into the offensive zone, looking to add another goal. He's already got one here in this period. His shot goes high and wide, but he picks up control of that loose puck, gets it to Davis on the dot, right out in front. He had McMahon there, but McMahon had a man in his hip pocket keeping him from getting a good shot off. McMahon's second shooting opportunity goes wide and out of the zone. And with 48 seconds to go in the Tampa power play, Buck starts it up from his own zone, getting it up to McMahon. McMahon gets it just inside the blue line, but Ryan Hahn takes it off of his stick, feeds it around behind the net to Ryan Kelly. Kelly chips it up to the blue line, getting it past the defenseman and clearing it down into Tampa zone. Now 30 seconds remaining on the Buff State penalty. Joe Lotempio with some pressure in the offensive zone, but Tampa breaking that pressure as carrying it into the offensive end is going to be Andrews. Andrews with Militello on him. Good job by Militello to get it past the defenseman. Just too far for Joe Lotempio as the captain was very late in his shift, unable to chase down that loose puck. It could have been a breakaway, though, if he would have gotten a hold of that one. Murray in, though. Murray with a chance. Made a move to get around A.J. White. Just couldn't get that shot in on goal as the waning seconds of the power play. Tampa with a great opportunity, but Hunt now has it wide open on a breakaway. Elliot Hunt in alone. Great save made by Grant as Hunt tried to beat him with the shot, high glove, and Shea Grant showing why he has a 1.20 goals against average. It saves like that on a breakaway by Elliot Hunt.
Yeah, Shea Grant is a big goaltender right there, and he uses his size to his advantage. Elliot Hunt comes in with speed, and Shea Grant wisely does not come out too high to challenge him because he doesn't have to. So that takes the deke away. All Hunt can do is just try to overpower him with a shot, and Shea Grant just sitting in that post. I mean, Shea Grant standing like, looks like he's about 6'3" out there. He just sits in that crease. There's nothing to shoot at. You just got to hope you either pick your spot perfectly or a trailer picks up a rebound because he was in perfect position right there. It looked like prime Pecorine right there, just using his size and giving you nothing to shoot at.
And then doing a good job of making sure there was no second opportunity, something we talk about with his counterpart at the other end of the ice, A.J. White. Great job there by Grant making sure there was no second opportunity, as the Bengals surely would have loved a second opportunity if it would have developed.
He might be the best goaltender we've seen the Bengals face probably since Fairfield when they brought Wyatt Alberigo out there. I mean, Grant is something else. He's outstanding.
But at the same time, Buffalo State really hasn't tested him enough.
No, but when they have, though, not only has he come to the it looked easy,
yes,
on both breakaways.
Agreed. Tampa with possession of the puck inside their own zone. 10 minutes and 42 seconds remaining in third period action. Errant pass gets intercepted by Kelly, and he gets it up to Alex Gosset, who chips it into the offensive zone. Number 23, Sacco, in behind the net, starting the breakout is just some light pressure from the Bengals. They turn it over in the neutral zone, though, as Ryan Miller brings it back into the offensive end. Miller stops and looks to create something, gets it back to the point. Ryan Hahn loads up the shot, in on goal, stick save made by the goaltender Grant, and then he held on with the glove as one of his defensemen pulled a Buff State player down and is now continuing to try to engage with him there in the high slot.
There is a penalty here, too. You want to be careful if you're the Bengals. I mean, I understand standing up for yourself, but you're about to get a power play right here.
Could be a couple of calls there made on that play as the goalie also jumped in to add his 2 cents to the altercation. Heading to the penalty box is Gavin McDonald, number 22. We'll have to see exactly what the calls here are on this play, but might have a power play opportunity for the Bengals here as this gets sorted out. I would have to guess there should be. And it is a holding call that is made. I guess that's a holding call.
I mean, you have to hold the guy to form tackle his face into the ice, so I guess it's not completely wrong.
So the Bengals getting a power play here, and they did a good job to not retaliate there and to even it up like they did at the end of the second period. So this is a critical power play opportunity for the Bengals, an opportunity that if they convert on it would be huge for them here in this game, trailing by a score of 4-0.
I mean, they'll have you want to stay alive here. I mean, there's going to be a heartbeat with this team if you can get a goal here. You want to get it quickly, but you want to make sure you get one. Bengals need to be smart here, though. They can't just grip it and rip it like they've been doing. They're going to have a chance to be able to get their shot. They just got to get it.
Tampa penalty to number 22, Gavin McDonald. 2 minutes for holding. McDonald, 2 minutes for holding. Time of the penalty, 9:42. Bengals setting up shop in behind the goal. Zach Schultz there with a man on him. Josie Davis with some good work to get it off of his stick, but Schultz gets the puck back. Keeps the play moving for the Bengals right up here against the near boards. Two different Tampa players in there with three Buff State players trying to dig that puck out. Finally does come out to the point to Gallivan. Gallivan drops a pass for Sardino, who has a lane, but a great shot block there by Parrish as Parrish went to the ice and took that shot right off the hip to make that block. Opportunity to get a shot in on goal there by Anton Rupert. Doesn't get through traffic. That gives Tampa a chance to clear the zone and send it back into Buffalo State territory with 1:09 in the power play. Gallivan setting it down, getting a pass up to Rupert in the neutral zone. Rupert now surveying things as he carries it inside the blue line. Rupert in the far corner now as the Bengals get things set up, and it comes back to the point to Guerrera. Guerrera walks across the blue line, feeds it across to Rupert. Rupert again now back to Guerrera. He had a little bit of difficulty handling that, and Guerrera's shot attempt gets blocked on the way through. Now a 2-on-0 opportunity. Cody bringing it in, fakes the shot, right across, and buried by Ryan Andrews.
There, that's tough right there. I mean, Guerrera takes a slap shot when he had absolutely nothing to shoot at, blew it into shin guards, then went down trying to stop the breakaway, and it becomes a 2-on-0. Then there's no, A.J. White actually did everything right there. I mean, he got over in time, but there's nothing you can do when they can just wait and wait and wait. I mean, they could have waited an extra 10 seconds before they put that puck, before they put a shot on net, for any Bengals players had a chance to get near him.
Kind of been the theme of this game and probably this weekend as a whole. Some questionable decision-making from the Bengals. Poor choices made on the ice and ends up resulting in goals in the back of their net. They got away with it a lot last night coming out with the 8-7 win over Central Florida. They're not getting away with it tonight against this very talented Tampa squad, as that goal makes it a 5-0 lead for the Tampa Spartans. Tampa now looking to continue to add to it as they get the puck into the offensive zone. Fifth Tampa goal scored by number 2, Ryan Andrews. Assist to number 9, William Cody. Andrews from Cody. Time of the goal, 11:06. Puck in the offensive zone for Buff State here as the Tampa penalty comes to a conclusion. Elliot Hunt letting a shot go from the perimeter, right in on goal through a screen. Jolo Tempio there for the screen and deflection opportunity. But a good job by Grant to make sure that that shot didn't get past him. Cole Newman dumps it into the offensive zone, but the Spartans pick it up and have plenty of room to start their breakout. Long pass through the neutral zone finds Stephen Buck with speed into the offensive end. He gets a backhand shot in on goal, A.J. White has to do a good job of maintaining his position there, strong against that far post, squeezing that shot into his chest, making sure that there was no rebound and that it didn't get through, making very good save on that one. 7:52 now remaining here in third period action. Still a 5-0 lead for the Tampa Spartans.
Bengals have just had the script flipped on them of what they've been doing to teams lately. I mean, they played a decent enough first period to come out of there scoreless. Got the gut punch in the second period, and then Tampa is just pedal to the metal, and they're just they've got them on the ground, and they're just kicking them now. And again, high quality chances.
Shot taken there as there was another screen in front. A.J. White had to do a good job to make that save. Puck comes right back out in front. And another prime scoring opportunity as Cameron Sacco snuck in from his point position to get that shot right in on goal. White had to make another solid save. Looks like there's a little bit of a back and forth going on between Ryan Miller and one of the Tampa players. Miller looks to be in a little bit of discomfort, trying to get to the bench, runs into a different Tampa player as the puck comes back into the Buff State zone. Ryan Hahn stepped on it as he came onto the ice. Almost too many men on the ice penalty there, taken again by the Bengals, as the passing just doesn't connect here at the Tampa blue line. But Ryan Hahn finding that loose puck before losing control of it, tripping over the blue line, 3-on-1 developing for Tampa. Pass comes across, but some good defense as Alex Hussey made himself a big target in the way in the middle of the slot there, keeping that pass from getting across. 6:40 now in the third as another pass gets in behind the Tampa defense. It's going to be Sardina in alone. Tries to go to the backhand, just couldn't get that one in on goal. Tampa now coming back with speed in the opposite direction as it's going to be carrying through the neutral zone. Sacco drops a pass as Carrant tries to get it in on goal. Puck now in the near corner. Ryan Hahn plays it along. He's got Cole Newman in the far corner. Newman wraps it around the boards. It doesn't get past the defenseman, though, and Tampa keeps things moving. Carrant trying to get a shot away, but he had two different men on him, just dumps it into the far corner, as Tampa is obviously just happy to keep it in the offensive zone here as they lead this game by 5 goals with 6 minutes to go in the third. Tampa dumps it in, but gloved out of the air by Ryan Kelly. Kelly now tries to get a step on the Tampa player, but some very solid defensive work there by 29, Carrant. Carrant was the one that dumped it into the Buff State zone to start that playoff with. He stuck with it, though, and made sure that Ryan Kelly didn't get past him to create a scoring opportunity. Bengals, though, in the offensive zone here as Zach Schultz moves it along to Sardina. Back to the point to Ryan Kelly. Sardina and him play catch there as the Bengals look to create something, but Tampa doing a very good job of keeping the Bengals on the perimeter here. Kelly keeping it in at the near point. Gets it down to Sardina, but he loses control of it. Now it's Josie Davis with speed through the neutral zone. 1-on-3 here as Davis just rips the wrist shot, and he beats A.J. White on the blocker side. It's now a 6-0 game as Josie Davis gets the 6th goal for the Tampa Spartans here on an absolute laser of a wrist shot.
Yeah, Tampa's been able to do pretty much whatever they've wanted to for pretty much the entire second and third period, and Josie Davis, who's been a puck possession monster all game, picks up the puck, you know, glides in, you know, looking like he might pass it. Then all of a sudden just puts a snapper and just whistles it by A.J. White. And Tampa puts up 6 on the Bengals in their home barn.
Bengals hadn't given up more than 5 all season. And they've given up 6 here to the Tampa Spartans, and there's still 5 minutes remaining. Two Bengals almost collide in behind the net as Ryan Hahn starts to start the breakout up the near side. Puck into the neutral zone, quickly sent back in by Kukis as we are under 5 minutes to go here in the third. 6th Tampa goal scored by number 28, Josie Davis, unassisted. Davis, unassisted, time of the goal, 14:43. Shot attempt there by Elliot Hunt, hits a stick and goes wide. But the Bengals keeping it moving in the offensive zone, but only briefly as Tampa doing a good job of swarming to that loose puck and clearing it out of the zone, sending it all the way back into Buff State territory, now creating a turnover, slap shot taken right off of that turnover by Frank Catalina, and a glove save made by A.J. White, keeping this a 6-0 game. Tampa certainly not letting their foot off the gas one bit here with their 6-0 lead.
No, they're not, Aaron. And on top of that, Buffalo State continues to help them on top of it. I mean, another turnover leading to a prime scoring chance, and A.J. White hasn't mailed it in yet either. He was high on top of his paint and still had to extend and make a nice glove save right there. I mean, you would think the Bengals need to at least play a strong end of this game just to come out of there with something to build on. Like, they've got nothing.
Ugh. Big hit there in the far corner, adding a little bit of insult to injury or injury to insult, whichever one is the case here.
Insult to insult.
Exactly. 4 minutes and change now remaining as Tampa continues to do a very good job of moving the puck around the ice, getting it up ice and in on the offensive zone. That dump-in just ended up in on A.J. White. Had a couple of different options to move it, just decided to keep a hold of it himself, and holding on for a whistle, it will come up to his blocker side with 3:58 remaining here in the third period. And our coverage is brought to you by Town Auto, a proud member of the Western New York community for over 50 years. The dealerships of Town Auto make buying a car easy, whether online, over the phone, or in store. We love our town. Tampa with the puck in their own zone, as it's going to be McDonald starting the breakout up the near side. He has two different Bengals watching him, but he gets it deep into the offensive zone. Fires a shot in on goal. Looked like White had a little bit of difficulty handling that one.
Here
now
comes.
We have a little bit of a scrum to the left of the net as one player ends up down. The player comes in from the point to join the scrum as well, as it looks like it's McDonald wrapped up with Branca there just to the right of the cage.
Yeah, Branca went to clear him after A.J. White covered the puck, and then, you know, it just ensued right there. Sardina came in.
That's the second time McDonald's been involved in one of those altercations.
Is he one of those, do you think?
I think so. Anytime he sees an altercation, wants to jump into it.
That's all I've seen him do today. That might just be his role on the team.
Well, he quickly went to the penalty box, so he's accustomed to doing that. He didn't take his stick with him, though, and Ryan Hahn's retrieving it for him.
It's not like he uses it.
Branca and the Tampa player McDonald getting penalties here on the play. And there are 2 minutes up on the Tampa side. We'll have to see whether or not Buff State. Oh wow!
I don't think that was intent. No.
The referee has gone to the bench to retrieve it.
I don't think that. I giggled at that. I don't think that was intentional. Might have been, but I don't think it was. Granted, don't mess with the man's stick, Aaron. I mean, those things aren't cheap anymore.
Looks like coincidental minor is going to be the call here, and the teams will skate 4-on-4 with 3:40 remaining here in the third period. Both minor penalties for roughing on the play. As we get restarted here, Ryan Hahn carrying it into the offensive zone, taking a hit and getting the better end of that one as he was stepped into by number 4, Piccarello. But Piccarello may be deciding that probably wasn't a great idea if he had to do that one again.
Yeah, probably not. I mean, there's something to like. Oh, Piccarello makes a great defensive play there on Ben Gallivan.
Penalties on the play for Buffalo State, number 91, Colin Branca, 2 minutes for roughing. And for Tampa, number 22, Gavin McDonald, 2 minutes for roughing. Branca and McDonald, 2 minutes each for roughing. Time of the penalties, 16:20. Puck sent back down into the Buffalo State territory. Icing will be the call on this play with a little less than 3 minutes to go in third period action. It is still a 6-0 lead for the Tampa Spartans as they have been pretty much in command of this one throughout the second and third periods. Buff State did a good job of hanging with them in the first, probably give the edge to Tampa in the first period, but it was 0-0 coming out of the first 20 minutes. And then Tampa just put their foot on the gas to start the second period, and Buffalo State hasn't been able to catch up.
No, they haven't. Tampa's pretty much been able to do what they want, when they want, how they want. And, Buff State, the effort's been there for Buff State. I'll give them that. It's not like laziness. It's just, you know, trying fancy stuff on a team that's not going to work on, you know, not good passing, you know, frustration, guys trying to do too much themselves. You're not going to beat a team like – you're not going to beat these Tampa Spartans like that. And when these two teams meet again, I expect the Bengals to have a completely different game plan.
Yeah, Tampa's certainly not a team that you can come out and play the same way you play against Canisius, like, and I think the Spartans have done a good job of showing the Bengals that they are not a team to be trifled with and certainly not to be taken lightly.
No.
And Tampa is a team that is definitely going to make, in my opinion, going to make some noise when it comes to CHF Nationals in April.
I would be shocked if they didn't have a nice run in that tournament.
They've already been tabbed as the team to watch, the team to beat coming out of the state of Florida. And you can see why. They do a lot of things very well. They pass the puck well, they skate well, and they defend it as well. And getting another late opportunity, Stephen Buck getting the shot in on goal as they executed that stretch pass yet again.
Perfectly.
Both teams like to do that stretch pass. They like to get it through the neutral zone, but only Tampa's executed it here tonight. Bengals haven't had much success at all when it comes to those long passes, and they've basically been given a clinic by the Tampa Spartans here.
Yes, absolutely. And the one thing on top of everything else, because I am not sure I would say this Tampa team is much more talented than these Bengals, if they're more talented. But what they are is extremely disciplined, and they play within their system to perfection. Defensively, they're outstanding. Every pass is on the tape. Everything's done with purpose. You haven't seen a Tampa player try a fancy, a highlight reel move once. Everything is
the smart play.
Yes, the safe, the right play.
Yeah.
And not that there's not a place for that. I mean, we've seen Ben Gallivan embarrass defensemen. There's nothing wrong with it. It's part of the game. But you know what? Read the room. That doesn't work on these teams. But you know what? Maybe I I like to be a half full optimist. Maybe midseason, facing a team like this and, getting punched flat in the mouth. That might be it. Like, hey, this is not – not to be disrespectful. It truly isn't. But is anybody going to sit here and say – you can say a Canisius is going to give you what this team's going to give you. It's you're not. I mean, they came up from Florida. These Florida teams aren't going to send teams that aren't going to compete. That's just a waste of everybody's time. And you're getting a look at what you're going to have to go through if you want to make more noise than you already have at Nationals. So this is a good measuring stick. But as you can see, there's a lot that needs to be worked on by this Bengals team if they're going to be like this Tampa team.
Yep. This is going to be the second loss of the year for the Buff State Bengals. And they responded very well to that first loss, losing their home opener to Niagara here in this building. And they rattled off a bunch of wins in a row right after that. Impressive wins, and played their best hockey of the year. That loss to Niagara served as a wake-up call for the Bengals. Maybe we'll see the same thing with this loss here to Tampa here tonight.
You just don't want to see anything dumb happen here in terms of, you don't want to see someone take a run at somebody. You don't want to see someone just do something not cool, for lack of a better term. I definitely don't want to use my hockey player mouth on the air right now, but just get out of here. Get out of here. You got beat by a better team today is what happened.
And you'll have another shot at him later on in the season.
In their building.
So finish the game off properly and get ready to face them again later on in the season. And get ready to face another tough opponent here next week as the Bengals fall right back into league play and a big divisional game against the St. Bonaventure Bonnies. Last couple of seconds ticking away here. And that's how this one's going to end. It is a 6-0 shutout victory for the Tampa Spartans. Shea Grant, excellent work in net. And really a top-to-bottom great effort from the Tampa Spartans. I would say every man in the white uniforms tonight played a solid game, was excellent from start to finish. They deserved their commanding victory here tonight, Sean.
Yes, they did. This is not a game where you're going to – you don't ever want to lose. And, you don't want to get it taken to you in your own barn. And Buff State has – there's plenty to work on and plenty to take in from this. But one thing nobody's going to say – the better team absolutely won. And honestly, Aaron, 6-0 might be merciful compared to what the score could have been were it not for some great goaltending by A.J. White early, and for A.J. White showing character and not quitting on his team and not hanging his head and not just sitting in his butterfly mad. The Bengals played. They were stretching the puck. They were trying to get opportunities. They were shooting. Today, what they have been doing to teams just happened to them. A team showed up. A team kicked him in the teeth, and then on the way down, kicked him again. But Captain Joe Latempio, the way that he is, the Bengals are going to remember this next time they play these UT Spartans. But also, I don't think these UT Spartans are going to take from this game and take the Bengals lightly either. If you're going to beat these guys, you got to bring your A game. The Bengals did not bring their A game, and I don't think you'll find a single player in black and orange for the second night in a row that'll tell you this was even a decent performance, much less a good one.
So we were looking forward to this weekend for certain with the two schools coming in from Florida to play games here in Buffalo against the Buffalo State Bengals, the UB Bulls, as well as Tampa playing tomorrow against St. John Fisher. And kind of a disappointing weekend from a Buff State perspective as they squeaked a win out last night 8-7 in less than impressive fashion. And then they get taken out behind the woodshed here tonight by the Tampa Spartans and they lose 6-0. So a lot to regroup from and try to rebound from for the Buffalo State Bengals here. And I think the watchword now as the team moves forward is how will they control the response?
Well, they're going to have to respond quickly because a very tough opponent and a tough opponent that's probably mad at you is next on the schedule. You went into Bonaventure's house and beat them. they're going to want to come into your house and beat you. And Bonaventure's capable of that. And I think the Bengals know that. I mean, it's league play. It's a local-ish opponent, a team that you're going to see a bunch of. So, I mean, Bonaventure, you know, that's another team. It's a team that's made some noise at Nationals. It's a team you're going to have to go through to accomplish your goal. So it's good news and bad news. Good news is you get an opponent that you have a chance to move up in the standings against an opponent that you've already beaten. You sweep the season, you can, you know, get 2-0 against them. But again, like we said after UCF, you play like that against Bonaventure, you're getting run out of your building. So the Bengals got to, you know, take a step back, look in the mirror, realize they did not play well at all. They, you know what? You might even go as far as say they played flat out bad today. You got to shake it off, learn from this. Because you got another opponent in here that if you don't bring your A game, they're going to punch you. So get a chance to regroup, but now the pressure's on.
Yeah, plenty of tests still coming up this month for the Buffalo State Bengals. It doesn't get any easier from here. Next Saturday, home game against the St. Bonaventure Bonnies, a big UNY-CHL West Division matchup as the Bengals try to get the sweep over the Bonnies and give themselves a commanding lead in the divisional standings. 2 weeks from tonight, we have the UB Bulls here for a 9:30 Saturday night start. And then the following week, it is Erie County Community College again, another Saturday night start on November 27th. Those two games are at 9:30. The St. Bonaventure game next week is a 7 p.m. start. Support for Buffalo State Club Hockey comes from 95 Nutrition. Healthy and delicious meal prep and delivery, making it simple to live a healthy lifestyle and reach your nutritional goals. Enjoy the convenience of healthy eating with 95 Nutrition. More information at 95nutrition.com. Supporters also include the law offices of Nicholas J. Narchis, an advocate for Western New Yorkers with blue-collar roots. Providing efficient and cost-effective representation from offices in Lockport and Geneseo, online narchislaw.com. Our coverage also brought to you by Hurdle Parker Liquor Store. With everyday low prices on a great selection of wines and spirits, the Hurdle Parker Liquor Store on the corner of Hurdle and Parker in North Buffalo. Support for Buffalo State Club Hockey also comes from Town Auto. For over 50 years, a proud member of the Western New York community, putting customers' needs first and helping them find the right car at the right price. The dealerships of Town Auto make buying a car easy, whether online, over the phone, or in store. We love our town. Supporters also include Militello Realty, Western New York's premier commercial real estate broker. For any buying, of selling, or leasing office, industrial, retail, or investment properties, trust the unparalleled knowledge and experience of Militello Realty. And our coverage also brought to you by Ivy Lee Pharmacy, a locally owned neighborhood pharmacy for over 60 years. If you're traveling to Canada, PCR COVID tests are available at Ivy Lee with a quick one-hour turnaround. Ivy Lee is at 2446 Elmwood Avenue in Kenmore, or online, ivyleepharmacy.com. Again, our final score here from the Buffalo State Ice Arena. It is the Tampa Spartans 6 and the Buffalo State Bengals nothing. We will be back here 1 week from now. It is a 7 p.m. start. The St. Bonaventure Bonnies here at the Buffalo State Ice Arena for a big UNY-CHL divisional matchup. So the Bengals' five-game winning streak comes to a close here. Rather, six-game winning streak comes to a close here as the Bengals lose this one by a 6-0 count to the Tampa Spartans. And Tampa heads into their game tomorrow looking for a 3-game weekend sweep of their trip to Buffalo. Our thanks to Evan Kump for his work operating the camera tonight. For Sean McHugh, I'm Aaron Elpern. Thanks for joining us tonight. Enjoy the rest of your weekend.